The live. We'll find out soon enough. There's the chat here. We'll show up on stream as well. And this is essentially the setup. Eventually we'll move here, as we mentioned.
I will say, I think the seating arrangements, given our heights, were a really genius idea. I, being the shortest, I'm closest to the camera. Seb is middle. And
no, don't say that, because then I should be the DM.
Fat actor.
Yeah, sad.
We can't go that far.
It is loading. We're still not live, I think.
We are live.
Are we?
Live there, not live there.
Not on my phone. Oh, an error. Okay, hold on a second. Let me reload.
We reload the whole thing. Reload that browser.
Fucking.
Shit.
What?
Skipped. Brain. Oh,
that was my stomach.
I heard.
Want something to help with that?
Hmm?
Huh? Want something to help with your stomach?
No. Okay. I'm hungry, that's the thing, because I haven't eaten all day.
Maybe not sound appetizing. You want some crackers?
No, I'm good.
Got brunettes.
We're a bunch of crackers, anyways.
We can't say that.
Oh, crap. I'm kidding. I love the white biscuits.
We are white biscuits.
Stiff. I had to fall back so quick.
Stiff, thin, dry, crumbles when you bite them.
Okay, so essentially, I think the
issue was... post.
It's currently using 50% of the CPU, but
That's weird to look at. God damn it, Kay.
Okay, that's pretty good.
Streaming 4K.
Dum dum dum.
What?
No.
Okay.
Wow.
I have 6K upload here, ironically. Alright,
I think that's ironic.
Can anyone see it?
See what?
I'll be.
I'll touch it from my end as well.
Nice case.
Thank you. Should be fine.
Screws come out easy, though.
That's kind of annoying. Shame.
Yeah, I lost two.
Do you have the...
I do. I have to tighten them. I have a couple. They came with 6 replacements, so it's like... I think they knew. Back to Dream Daddy.
Hey there, everybody. Today we're going to be playing Dream Daddy.
Absolutely.
Your stream.
Hello, yeah, Dream Daddy.
Is live. All right. Live. For now, who's live, can I confirm that everything's okay?
Who's tuning into us, actually?
I can check what the combi asked. Un momento. Alright.
Okay, apparently Abby sees us.
Okay,
that's nice.
Who's Abby?
Gabe can also see us.
Hey!
Hey, clap!
Hey, guys!
I have no friends who can see this.
We're your friends, man.
We're all
I'm stuck here with you guys. That's great.
I'm trying to throw your bone. Fuck you,
Jeez, man.
Should be fine. Camera's fine. Do we need additional light?
I think we're good. Oh, Jesus. Nah.
That's certainly additional.
There's one top down.
God.
If we want to see God.
Yeah.
There's a switch there.
Love it. Beautiful.
I can't.
Well, what? Nothing. We're no conspiring going on in this corner.
I think it's maybe the one that's plugged in.
I'm thinking that one too, but I don't want to just switch something off.
Imagine everything's dead.
Exactly. Yeah, no.
After all the time to
bed. Hour and a half sitting up.
I'm all for a bit of tomfoolery.
No.
Oh, yeah, give me. Thank you.
Yes. You guys need more dice trays? I can get.
No, I think it should be. It should be good.
I need one.
If you have one, yeah.
Dice tray.
Sorry, guys. I'm forcing the DM to do something for me.
I mean,
love you, boy.
or else we could just, guys, don't.
Oh, God, he's gone. Listen. We've been here for days. He won't let us leave.
Please help us.
Oh, yes.
Our location is.
This is the basement from Pulp Fiction, you know what I mean?
Oh, my God.
Too dark.
Right.
Too dark
a reference, man.
Wow. Crap. I will be needing the player's handbook because I am a paladin and I have prepared
shake
spells.
Shake the chains sometimes.
Shake the chains. There are chains, dude.
There are chains, man.
This is the basement.
I can't just look through the footage.
Oh, sure, go ahead. Don't worry about it, man. Like,
you can think of it like Easter eggs.
Ooh,
pretty funky.
Keep this one here. Just give it here. Whatever.
Do you need an adult?
Yeah, he's got it. They clip together.
Do you need an adult?
Have you tried the buttons, honey?
Jesus Christ.
Give him a break.
I love how this is live, so it's even better. It's just...
Hi, welcome to a very professional D&D stream where we're definitely not having budget cuts. Help.
And none of us are prisoners in this
None of us are prisoners.
We haven't been here for days.
Well, this isn't certainly a scary thing. Which one's,
sharing
the yellow? That one, right? That one's the thought. So I remembered that from far too many times of seeing it, Max. Far too many times.
Alright, so. For those of you that don't know, around 2 or 3 weeks ago, we had our session zero, which was just tackling everything. Westworld, I don't know if you managed to catch it or not.
I watched a little bit until I fell asleep.
That's fine.
No offense. It wasn't you guys, it was me. I was tired.
It's fine. Chat, I can't see you, so if you want to text anything and also redeem your points to basically do goofy shit, feel free.
Please don't.
Please redeem your points, chat.
I have a lot of points.
Along with everything, I will basically be the Dungeon Master. I am Rx100/Max. Over here we have...
Matthew, or name. Gerald Fitzlancaster. Matthew.
And you are playing a...
Oh, I'm sorry. I am playing a paladin, Gerald Fitzlancaster.
I feel like we're doing icebreaking games, not like school. Okay, My name is Sebastian. I'm playing a goblin called Chico Finley, and I'm a ranger.
Dach, und mein Gespodin Vladislav, I am artificer gnome, Kabloon.
Kabloon.
And thus, we've just offended every Russian everywhere.
Send
them
a
bottle. Can you move the mic a bit closer to me, I think?
You want your cup? You have a cup. This is your cup.
I think that's better.
That's fine. Contact as to why you might be hearing us at different variations of volume. We have one microphone as due to our lapel mics deciding not to work, and I'll be returning and hopefully getting my fucking money back. I want my 400 euro back.
Oh, oof.
Looking at you, Amazon.
Oof.
Amazon, you piece of shit.
Oof.
Don't say that. Bezos is listening to
you. You are set, Daddy Bezos.
Like, no.
Daddy Bezos. Dear God.
Alright. So for those of you, I'll be going over some house rules and shit like that. So first things first. Inspiration. I marked with these tokens. I forgot to get the bag. I can't be fucked. There's one inspiration. That's it.
Can I have it?
Yeah.
I was already reaching for it.
You basically get inspiration by doing certain RP moments and certain things, which I do find to be extremely in character, and basically sticking a lot with character. I'm a bit stingy with them, because obviously inspiration can be something that not only viewers can give you inspiration as well. Example, 5 euro donations give inspiration and they can include your character name. Along with
Gerald,
that, you can
Gerald.
Also use, yeah, you can also use channel points that will give you certain benefits such as indomitable and stuff like that, saving throw, rerolls and stuff like that. But they can also fuck you over, they can summon monsters, they can reanimate things and stuff like that.
Don't be dicks, guys.
Please be.
The
way
worst,
more fun.
Like, cost more specifically.
Good. Spend as much
Smart.
Dickness as you want.
Max needs your money.
Max needs your
He's
money.
An entrepreneur. Okay?
I'm not an entrepreneur. I'm a broke ass bitch.
Who wants to be
business.
An entrepreneur?
He's making it work.
Yeah,
he's
doing
straight,
it.
Man.
Hustling, man. It's hustling.
It's hustling. Alright. Along with that, first things first, most of the monsters won't be using their stat blocks, the default ones. I know most of you are veterans, for that simple sake. If your character doesn't know it, you shouldn't know it. I have a very strong policy against metagaming, meaning if you're going to be a cunt, I'm going to be a cunt. Okay?
Fair. Psychic damage?
Fair.
Yeah.
No, I will hit you in real life.
Oh.
I will stab
oh.
you.
Oh,
across
no.
the table.
Roll for initiative.
Roll for initiative.
In the basement?
At least.
Just grabs a chair out of nowhere, WWE style.
Rolls a d20. I got an 18!
Right now, this isn't the final setup that you guys will be experiencing in future sessions. Eventually, we'll have a camera here, which will allow us to have kind of a more side shot. Lighting isn't the greatest, I'm aware.
Feedback on the crotch cam under the table, if that's your thing.
There's a separate stream on Pornhub, specifically with the vibrating underwear.
Nice.
Nah, if you're not verified, man, it got deleted. Yeah, that's...
Let's not discuss that.
Featured news, guys.
Not an OnlyFans, yeah.
I'm just trying to say, man, if you're trying to make 5 euros a pop for inspiration, ain't nobody going to be dropping that. But if you can, you know, make someone's vibrating panties go off for 5 euros...
Listen, you're on the wrong stream for
you're
that.
You're on the wrong stream, yeah. This is
like
Belfine's OnlyFans.
A Christian
Let's go back.
Dungeons & Dragons stream.
We have a paladin here. God.
Christian Dungeons & Dragons. Have you ever played with me in any game? My only character you've seen me play with is a literal war criminal.
No, I've seen you play two characters, and they're both war criminals.
Alvatar wasn't a war criminal.
Wasn't he?
No. Wasn't he?
Wasn't if somebody's he in doubt, wasn't he I'm doubting you.
Okay, I might have broken some of the Geneva Convention.
I'd love to hear a lawyer's defense or the prosecuting attorney. I'm afraid my client wasn't a war criminal.
Wasn't he? Really?
Sure.
Anyway. With regards to the world that you're in, I'm going to basically doing a quick recap and some things that occurred between, well, session zero and session now.
You all died.
No, actually.
I have to remake my character.
Bob is still alive.
I'll just play Gobby again.
Now, Bob the Barbarian, my NPC, who was literally the definition of getting DDoS, is somehow still alive.
I recall Bob.
Is he just constant dial-up noises as he's running around? Nice.
It was basically your character.
Because
you didn't show up.
God, man, you should have told me you made a barbarian named Bob. I would have totally been alright with making a character as that.
He's still alive, but he's now kind of like he's finally returning his watch along with what he had. He basically, your goblin had gotten killed in the fight, along with, remember what the hell you were.
Myself?
It was a drow.
Yeah, I was some drow sorceress, warlock, I don't know.
You were a drow sorceress, you had gotten maimed and basically had to be taken out of the line of fire, and there was a Mark's character who also had to be taken out of the line of fire.
Chico's
the only one who died.
You used the term
Chico got trampled in the first stampede.
That's horrible.
Sorry.
Are you like the aunt's ancestor of Chico?
Well, apparently. Yeah.
Just add a number two.
The second, yeah.
but with that being said, Chico was also seen as a war hero, as due to his trampling, an army had slipped over the side of the mountain and died.
Yeah, I was the banana peel.
Exactly.
Your blood was the slickness. Yeah. Oh, Christ.
The whole army fell off the side of the mountain.
After the invasion,
one war elephant.
Large metallic doors. Okay, let me actually do a full recap. I just wanted to mention like who was still alive, wasn't.
Mm-hmm.
You guys find yourself within the land of Marita, a land that is constantly surrounded by fog. The reason for the fog is either seen as something spiritual or a curse. No one's still sure of this. On this particular island, certain factions of evil reside. You have the people who are the Novarich, the new rich, and you basically have the people who are like the farmers and the fishermen. Plains. So there's always the area of slums and there's the area of humongous
among the
buildings.
Thank you.
Excuse me.
And then there is one particular region which is always seen by all, the mountain. The mountain is essentially somewhere that's always kind of cold, very frigid. The air is always very, very frigid. Once you get up the mountain, you are basically instantly seeing. I know there's a lot of fog here, I'm sorry.
It's adding really to the mystique, you know. We're digging in.
Essentially. Fuck what I'm saying. Once you get on top of the mountain from the frozen peak, you are able to see this large cave system, which was what some speculate to have been a volcano once upon a time. From the volcano, creatures began to kind of slither out. Some of them called them changelings, others called them shifters. No one's quite sure. They eventually got the dwarves in the mainland to commission a large iron gateway. Once the iron gateway was put in place, the fog appeared. When they attempted to take away the doors, it didn't change it, so they put them back up. They're not quite sure what the cause of the fog is. Is it basically God being like, how fucking dare you? Or is it something else? Along with that, after that point, ships found it extremely hard. Lighthouses were assembled and very little boat traffic was even allowed. Most of the people that even attempt to come into your region are mostly fishermen. They basically get fish from your surrounding areas, which are very tropical. They have a lot of tropical fish, which are kind of seen as a
delicacy,
exactly.
Okay.
I like me a nice roasted clownfish in the morning. Finding Nemo? No, finding breakfast.
Nemo, no!
That seagull didn't put him where he needed.
With
the
that
pelican.
Being said, most of the islands call you a myth at this point. Most of the continents do not know that you actually exist, and the few that do will avoid you at all costs.
It would be a seafarer's tale.
Were that like off the beaten trail and everything, basically.
Yes, and along with that, your island is surrounded by a number of kind of like ridges, shipwrecks, which cause it to be very, very difficult for like large naval ships to actually approach you.
Alright,
hence
shoals.
Why a lot of fisher ships kind of go in, because they can just basically put an oar out. If they feel it, they turn.
Okay. And how thick is the fog? Like, really, or it depends on the day.
It's constantly, you can see 10 feet out at sea.
Yeah, it's pretty bad.
It's essentially like, soup. It's soup.
Yeah. I can imagine in all these years someone has, you know, tried to see if the fog is magical in origin.
They believe that it is magical in origin, but they do not know the cause.
Okay, but it has no magical properties in and of itself. It's regular water vapor.
They just see water vapor, but example, they don't believe that it's made by a druid. They don't believe that it's made by anything else. And they have sent people out of the fog. The thing is, given that the ships that are needed to made it need to be specifically made on the island, they basically send the people that go on the watch after their watch is over. And I know this is sounding Game of Thrones. I do not intend it to sound that way. It
really is, because they're just practically sending them to their death in a way, aren't they?
I mean, the last party died.
The last party died, that was you guys, before right? that particular event, 100 years had passed since the last invasion. So there were a lot of watches that actually got to come and go.
They're just watching.
They're just watching. And even they now, watch it. Fast forwarding after that invasion, you are essentially the third generation after that.
Okay.
It's been another 100 years. There have been no invasions as of that point. Yes?
100 years? I thought we were sent off every time we hit like the age of consent. So in that case, they're 18. No.
All of them are still 18.
We are 18. I'm 18?
But if I'm an 18-year-old gnome, I'm considered a super young gnome.
Yeah, and, pretty young.
And how old the...
He's a baby.
I'm an ancient goblin. Yeah, I'm an old goblin.
Remember what we said about goblins. They found the secret of life. It's yeast.
Yeast, yes. Yeast. Lots of yeast. Just eat all the yeast.
You are force-fed yeast to remain young.
It's disturbing.
That is very disturbing.
Ah, yes. Welcome to our Christian D&D stream. Force-feed goblins yeast.
And also the 18 years old thing kind of negates the old tough character, which was a shit I was rather looking forward to.
I know, it would have been rather great if you asked me.
Keep in mind that you guys are technically 18 years adopted. You could have been maximum of ages from 3 to 5 when you were taken away by
but the... But no one would have known your age.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, so... you know, I could look like 96. I'm 18. I swear, come on.
He'll be a young lad. If he lives long enough, he'll turn into a gruff man.
Each time the watch is selected, essentially, the Papa Yaga will take recruits, such as what happened last time, and he will train them in his own specific way. Today's session, we'll be tackling the Papa Yaga's upbringing with you. He'll give you certain benefits and certain individual traits. Okay? So for now, it will be a bit of one-on-one each. If you guys want to go smoke, up to you. But essentially, we'll have scenes with each other. Example, you could be sparring with another. It could lead to scars. It could lead to wounds, etc., etc. You can't obviously die in the...
Mad crippling.
If you take off my arm, you better give me an arm.
Listen, your character is the one who cut off my arm last time, but it was technically in the control of that guy over there. I noticed earlier when you said I got maimed, if you it was the passive voice, not the active voice. I maimed you, rather than, oh, you got maimed, oh, I don't know who did it.
I used that in his campaign where I had my active and passive voice. I used my passive voice at one point, and I said, I put on a ring in the passive voice. And he was like, you put on a ring? and it was just like, I didn't say that, you did. And I was like, I didn't use my voice. And I think I did.
I was talking about grammar, like, but that's okay.
It was just accidental.
So you guys want to rock, paper, scissors on who goes one-to-one first?
Up to you.
Yeah, not it. Yeah, Rochambeau. Mm-hmm. He's got P is why I'm asking, but I'm happy to
say that. No, I'm not in it, so it's up to you guys at this point. Right? Yeah, it's him.
Sam, you're up.
Okay. Right.
Enjoy.
Thank you.
Well, second, I thought you were gonna go pee off the balcony.
I'm just gonna scooch around. Yeah, don't worry about it. I'll scooch around. You stay where you are.
Well, guys, a tiny little ad break.
yes.
Stream is brought to you by stuff on the internet.
And things.
Yeah, and things. Yeah. Many, many things.
Lots of things.
All the things.
They can't see you.
Exactly, they can't see you. They have no idea what I'm doing.
No, it's just gremlin
being
mode.
Weird, yeah, and it looks like a goblin.
Sorry.
I'm the only goblin here.
Last time I played a goblin, it wasn't a good thing. I'll be honest. He was a mess because I prepared a character. I didn't prepare a character sheet because I thought Max was gonna hand me a character sheet. I ended up there and he was just like, "You have a character sheet?" I was like, "Crap, no." He was like, "Are you serious?" I was like, Max, tell me what class, what races you have. Blah, 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 goblin. Okay, I'm a goblin. What races, what classes are there? Blah, blah, blah. Okay, I'm a rogue. I was like, goblin, rogue, done. Made a sheet. The guy's name was Gobby.
Oh, dude.
Exactly.
Dude.
He's Gobby the Goblin.
Gobby the Goblin. No.
Hey, man.
He spoke like this, and it was not good.
Gobby the Goblin.
Close the door, I'm not complete.
Sorry, what?
If it doesn't close the main door.
Do you need to be left alone for this?
No worries.
Don't leave me.
So remind me your character name.
Chico.
Chico. Alright, so. You are taken from your home at the ripe young age of 4 years old. You are working your father's potato field. Specifically. You're just eating half of it, and your father, knowing that you are a little shit, basically decided to opt you for the watch. You are pulled away by the Papa Yaga in, her, in his cauldron as he slowly pulls himself out.
I bite the Papa Yaga.
He enjoys it. You just see a smile on his face of pride. Ah, yes, a feisty one.
That's not good.
Christian stream.
Chico gets.
Chico eventually ends up getting put into the Papa Yaga's hut. Can you pass?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Gets put into the Papa Yaga's hut as you find yourself now beginning to slowly get trained. You are being fed yeast every year so that you can basically keep your mature body. You eventually grow numb to the taste. He feeds you fine foods.
You're laughing at mature body, right?
No, I love the fact that, like, yeast is the secret to life for goblins. Like, it's brilliant.
It's canon.
Continue.
It's fucking yeast.
I hated it at first, but now it's pretty good.
Yeah.
Jesus Christ.
Goblins get both.
Yes. You permanently have a yeast infection.
Yeast infection. I am a yeast infection.
You are the infection.
As you are being brought up, you eventually kind of grow wary of the Papa Yaga. He's very, very kind to you, but you weren't shown this kindness at a young age. You were always kind of sent out. But eventually you do semi-grow to acknowledge him as being a protector, if you will.
Yeah. Whatever, Papa. Yeah, yeah. Right.
You're British.
I'm not. What's a Brit?
Like to use this term.
I need to get used to the voices. I need to get used to the voices.
As time goes by, eventually you see that he does bring additional people. More specifically, he brings...
Hello. Hi. My name is Gerald. It's a pleasure to meet you.
Hello, Gerald.
Why is he a goblin? I thought it'd be humans. Alright, never mind, I'm looking at Baba Yaga. Baba
Yaga. I'm sorry, have you looked at me? Half my body is in a pestle and mortar, for Christ's sake.
I know, it's rather weird.
Classic.
Oh, that was your legs, Papa.
No, my legs got chopped off due to a large incident where they believed I was a witch.
Are you getting over it?
Oh. Alright.
You take 14 points of psychic damage.
Holy crap! Really?
Because of that pun.
Oh, man. Just get over it. It's 39 minus 14.
I think it's fair to say 25. That we grew up in a very abusive household.
Man, I just got here. No, I went Scottish there, but...
I got you into this house, I can take you out. He dangles you over the bloody Babaga's hut's mouth. Oh no.
Please no.
And eventually, along with that, after like 2 months, you will eventually show up.
How old are we?
We're 18.
You're 5 to 6 years old.
Oh, crap.
Well, you're very articulate for 5 to 6 week-year-olds. Oh, I'm going to say that.
Oh, wait, hold on a minute. What?
A year old. Even a year old, I mean.
Yes.
Oh, wait, no, hold on. I will change my voice. Definitely I'm a kid now.
With a weenie adventurer party.
Yay!
Woo! Oh, let's go on adventures.
Oh, yeah. I'm supposed to be young, innit? Yeah,
you sound like you smoke with
so much. Goblins, so this is really awkward.
Yeah, goblins.
We're all the same height, and the goblin's like 18 years. Like, he's an adult already.
He's there, he's got a goatee, got a cigarette.
God, I think I might need to change part of my backstory.
As all of this is occurring, essentially, you're all brought up in different months, with different talents. This is the way you're introduced to one another. Sometimes each of you will be incorporated in different ways and you will be getting different attributes. As you are brought up, he kind of gives you a choice of weapon.
Yeah.
What do you pick?
Well, I like to stab things and I like to shoot things. Can I take a dagger and a bow?
I don't see why not.
All right.
Kind of like takes off the leather thing and he just kind of like hands you the option to pick from. You kind of take those. If you want, I can offer you a crossbow as well if it's more of your discretion. Or would you rather have a
bow? I think I'll take the longbow because I could use it as a pole vault.
And I try pole vaulting with the crossbow. With the thing. Natural 8. I smash into the side, I smash into the thing. Knock over a bunch of pans. Ah,
fuck. Rat falls on your head.
Rat. I tried to eat it. Can I eat it?
Oh my god. Opportunist.
17.
You get... the trait opportunist.
Do you want some?
Opportunist. I'm
you, from you. Doing that, you get the trait opportunist.
Oh, okay.
You actually get that as a trait.
Alright.
You basically take every opportunity that you can get. It is now a character thing. Obviously, if it's something that will benefit really you, and or will get you go. Why did you wink at me?
I just like closed one eye, dude. It wasn't supposed to be.
I closed really one eye.
I'm like, I'm adjusting my mask on this side.
Do you know what winking is?
I'm so used to Jack doing that, and then I feel molested under the table.
Just a wink, man. Like,
I have PTSD bro, chill. From Jack. God, I don't like it.
Chill. It's fine.
Yeah, that time I did totally wink at him.
Totally.
Alright, so fast forward around 6 years. You're kind of now proficient with both your weapons. You both have the proficiency in this, piercing weapons, your bow and your dagger. And you also learn how to throw them feasibly. So you can add your proficiency to when it comes to throwing daggers.
Cool.
You now have a total of 8 throwing knives, which you have on you at all times. After battle, you can pick them up.
Cool.
If you remember.
If you don't, I will remember.
Or the stream will.
Yes. The stream is very much going to be a dick.
Yep.
What?
You had 12 gold in that session, but then you had 14 in the next. Where did that 2 come from? Wait a minute.
Alright. As you are kind of being brought up, the Papaya girl also tries to teach you some literature skills. Roll me 4 intelligence checks.
Oh, this is going to go well.
I would fail so hard on them if they come to me.
Oh, that's a 5.
Next.
That's a 20. Mm-hmm. Not natural. Dirty. That's a 19.
I like how you're yeeting it, man.
Yeah, really.
That's a natural one. That's a 3. So, 4. That's very natural even, you know? So, like half really bad, half really good.
So, natural one basically is going to somehow be cock, so you basically only get 1 check correct. As he kind of tries to teach you literature, which will basically improve your religion, your economy.
I don't care about that, Papa Dog. What?
At one point, you fall asleep during one of the sessions.
Good.
You can now pick which you're going to level up. You can either level up. By level up, it basically
gain proficiency.
Gain proficiency in arcana, survival, perception.
Uh-huh, okay. I have survival and perception already.
Or religion.
Okay, I'm gonna take Arcana.
Okay.
Because I like shiny things.
Thank God someone's smart here. Oh, wait, no.
I get bonuses to it too with intelligence checks relating to magic or history.
Why are you whispering?
Because
I'm pretty sure
they can still
hear us. This is meta gaming and you fucking kill us for that.
Yes.
That's why I'm whispering.
I mean, he literally.
Why is everybody whispering?
Yeah.
The first time I went to Baba Yaga, he gave me 15 points of psychic damage.
I wonder what you saw.
You get those back, by the way. Alright, so as time goes by again, flash forward to a few days before you have to go up to the watch. The Baba Yaga calls you over to the kitchen alone as a kind of turns to you. My boy, your time soon here, we will know that for a fact. I won't be able to join you up on the mountain, as that is not my duty. With that being said, I will be able to provide you with one last meal. What do you choose?
What do I want to eat?
throughout this entire time, he's kind of also gotten you to not only just eat rats and shit like that, he has actually tamed your palate to an extent.
He's gotten you. He's gotten you to eat rats.
Like, you've eaten rats, you've eaten meatloaf, you've eaten chicken, cordon bleu.
Mystery meat.
You've eaten a lot of
like,
shit.
What a fucking range.
Wow,
of
this dude. You've eaten breaded rats, chicken
eaten
with
meatloaf.
Cordon,
I don't want to leave.
Cordon bleu. Damn, this guy. This guy's a chef.
Like, he will feed you a variety of things depending on what the current economy is.
What the
Papa, could I have a baby?
I don't like where this is going.
Oh, whatever. A baby cow is enough. I mean, just a baby cow.
Venison.
Yeah, whatever. A baby, but it has to be a whole baby.
It's the whole cow.
Yeah.
He kind of...
A pig is enough. A pig. I'll take a pig. Whatever.
He kind of pinches the bridge of his nose as he looks at you with disdain. You're never my favorite son. You take -1 to all your charisma checks.
What?
When it comes to magical creatures.
When it
comes to magical creatures. Because you start envisioning the Papa Yaga giving you that look and you're just like...
You can put it in your notes as daddy issues.
Daddy issues!
Forget the trick. Daddy issues. Jesus.
-1
So magical creatures don't like me because I want to eat them.
Yeah.
No, like you kind of have this very timid nature around you when you see a magical creature because you envision the Papa Yaga.
When you say a magical creature, what do you mean?
Creatures such as, I'm going to be very, very liberal, a lich or somebody with like a very large magical masculine figure specifically.
Okay.
So it is
daddy
literally
issues.
Daddy issues.
Okay.
So like
magic daddy issues.
Jin.
How's it going? Are they saying anything about
I don't know how to write this down. -1 to charisma checks versus daddy issues?
Versus magical creatures.
So.
Masculine magical creatures.
Masculine.
Humanoid.
Humanoid.
I have no idea where the bottle is. Do you have the bottle?
It's being tucked safely behind these legs.
I'm just glad you're over there.
Okay.
All right. So that is essentially the end of your arc. You basically gain only that because you failed some of the checks, but it's fine. Each of you will be getting different things and so on forth. Second, who's going? Also, chat. How is the audio?
Do you like the sound of our voice?
I have the chat on my phone, guys.
Who's gonna roast seduction on Baba Yaga first?
Wait, who's gonna roast Baba Yaga?
Roll seduction on Baba Yaga first.
I will.
It's the Papa Yaga in this case. Papa Yaga, it's canon.
Yeah.
Can somebody illustrate the Papa Yaga?
He's getting over it with a super swole dude on the top, right? You said it's a mortar and pestle. Like, it just sounds like a skin for getting over it.
Still haven't beaten it.
No, I haven't. Nah, get over it.
A bit low, but still hearable fine. Should I turn up the game then? Alright, you two, pick who's going next.
Yes.
I already said I was going next.
You're going next?
Okay. Gerald Fitz Lancaster's last.
Vladislav Mendeleev.
Oh god, I need to think of a voice.
It is not necessary. These voices, they are but the icing on the cake.
Yeah, but it allows me to, like, differentiate between me just as a person speaking and
yeah,
character.
That's important.
Like,
that is important, yeah. Because
I could just be like, oh, man,
I'm going to stab you. I think I'm going to do this. And it's like, oh, okay, so roll attack. I didn't. You said it.
What I mean?
Which is why I think I need a character voice. Max, look at me.
14
say
psychic
that.
Damage. 14 psychic damage.
Look at me and say that, Max.
Liar.
That okay, Max, much of a cunt.
We love you, Max.
I won't
love
do it on the street, but I'll do it after.
Which is now an issue for fuck's sake.
What?
Is it gonna hurt their ears?
Yeah, be careful.
Oh.
Yeah. Alright, gonna... so.
Should we just try and speak normally for a little bit? My voice is pretty fucking loud.
You have a lovely voice.
You remember, you're directly in front of it. You're directly in front of it.
You are directly in front of it. You see, I've got this nice 3 feet over here. It's providing a buffer between
you say that.
Between
oh,
me.
Fuck.
This is the voice of the Metatron.
Is it clipping
voice.
Badly?
No, I'm looking at it. It's okay. It's just my anytime I speak, I go yellow.
Yellow is fine. Red is the problem. Essentially, I kind of have to yell a tiny bit. It's fine.
Just make sure to keep my voice somewhat down. No worries, my friend. No worries.
I would try to get two of these, but you can't use two mics at once, sadly. Of this particular brand.
Unless you want to pick each other up.
Yeah. No, they literally have forced the software not to allow two mics.
What?
Wow.
That's pretty cheap.
I had two of these. I had to sell the other one.
Pr- pretty gypped. Like, that's pretty scuffed.
Because the idea was we're actually going to use two of these, because they're not really good, but only one allows it.
Silly. But, okay.
Yeah, such is life. All right. So, Alex.
Vadi, please.
Vadi.
Please.
You hate my roleplay?
Yes. Cut out your old thing in my Dungeons & Dragons game.
This is a Christian game.
Damn it.
Yes.
How dare you try to summon demons and fuck witches and slay bitches.
Yeah.
Fuck witches and slay bitches.
Vadi, please.
Vladi.
Vadi. Vadi. Vadislav. What is so Vladi. Difficult?
I have a lisp.
Oh, Gospodin, Gospodin Papa, my apologies. I did not think of this.
It is what you have a very deep voice for a 5-year-old.
you know, something about mysterious God. Backstory, explosion, larynxial damage, you know.
Just imagine
him. Educated for a 5-year-old.
I do have 19 intelligence.
It was just a gnome.
He thought it was a child. It's actually like a 50-year-old man. Yeah. It's like, I'm going to take you home, little guy.
You're stuck with me.
That is a very peculiar knowledge to have. He actually did roll the 19. He's going to keep a very wary eye on you. One of your traits is now observed.
What does observed mean?
You'll find out at a later point.
Oh, Jesus.
Okay. Like, maybe I'll wash you while you
sleep. Opportunist because he ate a rat. Observed because he kind of lied.
I did not.
Oh, no, sorry.
As you are kind of brought in, you are introduced to these two people. One of them is kind of nursing this humongous headache, rocking back and forth. And the other is just there. You see the end of a rat's tail in his mouth as you enter. Exactly like a spaghetti.
Spaghetti.
Exactly.
Don't touch my spaghetti.
It is low, Gospodin Goblin. My name is Vadi.
My name's Chico, buddy.
Why does he sound weird?
It's something to do with his larynx.
Explain weird to me. What is
what? What you're saying right now?
What I'm saying? Well, I'm introducing myself. My name is Vadi.
I think my head's hurting a lot more than, than I thought it was.
Are you okay, little boy?
No, he hurt my head bad.
He's kind of a bastard.
He really is.
Duh.
He's kind of a bastard.
I'm gonna go home.
Papa.
Papa! Holy crap!
Zero to 100 real quick. He's kind of one of those noble boys. He doesn't really know much outside of his own.
Bah.
Please don't spit on the actual.
I'm wearing a mask! How am I supposed to spit on the ground?
Wait, hold on, guys.
You should get inspiration, okay? Yeah, because he tricked you into thinking he actually did it. And he lost the inspiration, and it's gone. The one communal inspiration is gone.
The one communal.
I see.
Actually, that is the thing. You guys can give each other inspiration.
Oh, damn right.
So, essentially, if somebody is going to be like constantly giving one person inspiration, he can share them.
I want to do something stupid. Can you help me?
You watch yourself, royal boy. You make bad impression.
I swear, that's like 3 times now, man. I've just thrown it at you.
Anyway. Where was I? Fast forward a few years.
Yeah.
You're given the option of weapons. What do you choose?
Give me something that is equally capable of crushing a skull and blowing it off the shoulders.
He looks at you with great concern. You're 10 years old, little Timmy. What's wrong with the priest statue?
I have seen things, Papa.
You just look out of the design, you see me eating a goblin. And
I'm 10 minutes into this guy. I'm loving him already. I have seen things, Papa.
I'm just there, like, going, like, what the fuck is happening?
Something around that, maybe a Warhammer?
Yeah. It's Warhammer.
Alright,
I'll be the can crush a skull. I say, why don't you take a hand crossbow? So you have a ranged weapon.
Do guns exist?
Some guns exist, but he isn't offering them.
That's kind of what I was like implying with the blowing the head off shoulders, but being able to crush a skull with it, you know, like a shotgun, because you can bash someone to death with the butt.
Give me a persuasion check.
The persuasion. Ooh, this is not my strong point, but I will try. It is a 16. 16 plus 2?
18.
Plus my proficiency? Could we say I'm persuasive?
Are you persuasive?
Dirty little fucker. So that's my 18 total.
How much total?
18 total.
That's pretty good. He does begin kind of like moving around. He kind of goes to the back and he kind of like opens up a chest, takes out a large
then rusty thunder cannon. And they're kind of like, oh, this was one of my apprentices at one point. Maybe it will do for what you need. You can cudgel someone with it and you can shoot it.
Bah, bah, bah. Thank you. It's good.
So it kind of looks like a shotgun.
It kind of looks like a shotgun. I can never let you die. And essentially where you have the barrels, like where you would kind of like, imagine a little barrel where you break it down, there's like this area of like glowing crystal thing.
Okay, now can I roll some kind of check to see if I can pop this thing like I know how to use it?
With disadvantage.
Yeah, it's good. Disadvantage. I spit in the face of disadvantage. 12. That's a 19.
It's so hard to see.
It's difficult on the bike.
You accidentally bonk yourself in the face with the gun.
Bong! Do I take any damage?
You take 5 points of damage.
Like, does it do any long-term scarring effects on my nubile
roll
face?
Roll me a D100.
Oh, dear.
You roll above a 15 or?
97.
Sorry,
man. I'm good.
I look at the gun and I say,
"Hey, going under.
Why don't you weld like an axe head to the bottom of that so you could shoot and then smack him with an axe?"
Wouldn't it break the gun?
Why? No, it wouldn't.
Look at me.
What about
you? Magnificent. Look at me. I did not know you have such a brain in that green head of yours.
Well, actually, I'm pretty smart for a goblin, I must say.
Well, more ideas like that, I will start to believe it.
Yeah.
My dude looks dumb as bricks. Just straight up.
So what is a thunder cannon? Thunder cannon. Keep going.
I know my history. I'm a noble, so I hope I will read.
Oh, we were just talking about how the D12s aren't used enough.
Yeah, D12.
Yeah.
Whoa. Dope.
All right. So, fast forward to your last few days before he calls you in. You kind of
see. I become a strapping young gnome.
You're a strapping young gnome, you're literally strapped with
a strapping with ammunition. I have bandolier and bandolier.
Is it like this? Where you're just like, and
you're kind of called into the study this time around so that you can actually learn. At this point, he kind of like puts some books in front of you. Roll me 4 intelligence checks.
Yeah, books. I remember books. First one, +4, +2, +6. So the first one is 22. Second one is 17. Third one is 10. And fourth one is 20.
Natural?
No.
Oh.
30.
What are we talking about?
Intelligence.
Oh, okay.
Wow, I don't think I should have dumped standard in.
So that was 22, 10, 14, 20.
So you only got 2 of them. All right, you kind of end up, you're not that studious, but you do know that he's trying to teach you very basic skills and rudimentary things.
Studious. Yes. I believe you will find it is proper.
What did I say?
Studious. Can I make another check?
Having corrected your grammar? No.
Come on.
Roll your next check at disadvantage.
Oh, come on.
Forget the term, neo-Nazi.
It's unfair. I have to learn all your silly English prepositions and all your articles, and you don't even give me another book.
And if I've been making vodka for you for how long now, you piece of shit?
Okay, out of game. Do I have a drinking problem?
Yes, no one is becoming an alcoholic.
I mean, I do have an alchemist kit, so
I think you're speaking of brewers. And we all know that I eat a lot of yeast, so the leftover goes to brewing.
Oh my god.
So not only am I an artillery maniac and quite a disturbed individual, but I'm also one of those assholes who does micro brews and never lets you forget it.
And you must tell everyone about it.
Permanent flask of, like, it just never ends.
Yeah. Oh.
Eventually.
Alchemist jug, bro.
So what do I have?
You can either pick from the following. You can either get sleight of hand.
Sleight of hand.
Survival.
Survival.
Arcana.
I have Arcana anyway.
So you can't take that. You don't get expertise. It doesn't work that way.
Okay.
And fuck off. And or you basically gain the permanent ability to each day without spending the time, you get +2 research by default. Because you're an artificer.
+2 to research.
At any time.
Like, you basically get the points which you can spend without spending the time to research.
Dude, I'm taking that.
He's like, winning!
Like, 100%, yeah, I'm taking that. Okay, also, so plus two.
I have no faith in myself in getting anything from those five intelligence.
One more time.
You basically can either, you get plus two per day to your basic, I'll just call it research goal.
Yeah, that's what I, did, plus two daily research.
Yeah, so basically you will basically have a skill tree. You will have to spend, example, if you're having a long rest, you can tell me, hey, can I spend a few hours working on this?
Because of that little bit of RP over there between Seb and I, can we like preternaturally go through one of these checks to see if I manage to put an axe head on the end of my rusty thunder cannon?
Roll me a survival check.
Can I give him assistance, or
because it was his
try
idea,
try and help him out? Because I have survival proficiency.
So you won't have advantage. I won't allow you to roll. The way this works is, you can basically, if you have it as a proficiency, you can give someone.
Give advantage with, but you have to have proficiency. Oh, it's a nat
20. Nat
20.
Did you spot what he just pointed? You can now use it as a slashing weapon, which deals 1d8 specifically.
So 1d8 slashing. So when I run out of ammo, I get close, bach, right in the Achilles.
Or you stab and you shoot straight.
Oh my god.
Don't do this.
There's a lot of face touching with this guy. I love it.
Just oil and grease.
Just talk about what was just said in chat. Who is the dude closest to the camera? He looks and sounds like my damn doctor.
Maybe I am your damn doctor.
He's Canadian.
Hey, who is the dude closest to the camera?
You're Canadian?
The Simp King. Why is Simp King talking to us?
Not Simp King. Don't do the same mistake like that.
Oh, excuse
Wait,
me. Sorry, Simp King.
The guy's doctor's Canadian?
No, he...
Are you Canadian, Matthew? Canadian.
Are you Canadian?
I'm not Canadian, my dude.
I'm a Canadian, yeah.
Oh.
Yeah.
Glory be.
Michael, thank you. Well, I think.
No, okay.
I guess.
Sim King is Canadian, the person in the chat. Moving on.
Oh,
hi. Sim King.
Hello,
How's
Sim.
It going? I didn't know you were personal friends with that guy. I'm not your doctor. I'm a teacher.
I'm sorry we'd never met. I guess.
Give it a few years.
Yeah.
Anything else for me?
Your last scene before the final few days. You were called into the kitchen. I will not be able to make it up with you in the mountain, but I could perhaps prepare a meal for you. I have already prepared a 6 bottle of vodka for you.
Thank you, Papa. I appreciate that.
Would you like anything else? You fucking alcoholic.
We
swine.
Have a drunk.
Drunk, no matter.
Zen the term.
Who is an art therapist?
Papa, there are flies in my stomach. I think about the day ahead. Is there not something you could pack for me? Something I could take for the long term?
Kind of like gestures for you to sit down as he kind of like very awkwardly shifts the mortar and pestle to look at you. Yeah, it's just like...
Well, you're on the swivel chair, you got it.
It's just that.
As he's doing so, in the like from the outside, you hear...
Just eating.
The Timmy's falling into the goblin now. Oh no.
Mad.
It's me eating my piggy. Oh. I'm eating my piggy.
My son, there is not much I can tell you with regards to how to deal with the fear that you are going to face up there. Although I may not be with you, I will...
No, no, Papa! Fear? You misunderstand. I am excited. I am excited to put this cannon to use.
So you have diarrhea?
What?
Duh.
Tummy tickles. Tummy tickles.
Tummy tickles, duh.
So you take the constant liquid shit. Why am I slowly turning Russian?
I don't know why we've RP'd that I've got diarrhea. I was just trying to tell you that I'm using the thunder cannon. Okay. My butterflies are out of excitement rather than...
Ah.
I thought that was the implication.
So you are basically excited to get to the front line.
Duh.
You gain the trait concerned.
So I'm observed and concerned.
Both.
You are very, very... You have... Okay, so observe... Throughout the majority of your youth and even adult life, you have the constant feeling of being watched.
You
gain a plus one to perception.
Oh, nice. Plus one perception.
You're always looking over your shoulder. Because there are moments where the Papa Yaga is there like, is he going to kill a child again?
Again.
I did not... talking to the goblin who eats babies.
I would if... I could have access.
You're talking to the opportunist goblin who would eat babies.
I would have stabbed you if you tried to eat a baby.
But they're so tasty.
No, I would have killed you.
Why?
No, that is just not in my...
Is it okay to eat a baby cow?
Blue blood fingers off of the goblin.
Yeah? Yeah, they're stock. They're food for us.
Oh, alright. So it's alright if it's a cow baby, but a human baby's not.
No.
What about a cat baby?
Would you eat a goblin baby?
Fuck yeah.
All right, never mind.
Gerald walks. He just throws his armor off. He's like, fuck this shit.
Lions eat their babies all the time, mate.
And that's fucked up. It's like, let's keep walking.
You concern me quite a lot, my son. You know that.
Yeah. You have said many times, Papa.
You really need to start dealing with your alcoholism, which is now your trait.
Papa, with all due respect, you are the one who kept brewing me vodka for all these years, ever since I was a 10-year-old.
That is true. You asked for it. Your parents specifically requested it.
I like how you are mimicking my accent now, Papa.
I have a problem, please.
Can we all mimic the accent?
It is impossible not to turn on to the Russian when you hear it.
Why are we doing this? Oh,
it's
no.
Difficult.
No, man, I need to think of Gerald.
What I'm saying is your parents specifically requested that you become a drunkard, but something with regards to your family lineage.
Wow.
Wow. You know, and I had this, like, dark backstory in mind. Not like, you can probably tell from the character.
Yeah, but
my parents wanted me to be drunk.
Yes.
It's a family trait.
It's a family tradition.
Yeah.
Do I get a bonus for that?
Yes. Iron gut.
Huh?
Iron gut.
Iron gut. What is, I don't know.
You can eat anything even if it's rotten.
Oh, cool.
Because you've basically killed your liver and stomach.
Amazing.
What about the opportunist?
Do I get
here
bonuses
well?
Against poison?
No.
You eat rat. Well, then again, you're a goblin who eats rats.
I'm pretty sure
every single time you speak, everyone around you has to just do this.
I mean, you eat yeast at
least. The look of concern.
Live active yeast.
Does this give me a bonus to intimidation checks?
No, they're just really concerned.
Okay, so you're all very concerned.
This is me constantly, like...
Oh, I don't know if we should let him do that.
No. He's his own man, leave him alone. Oh, wait, oh, this is great. I'm you concerned. Guys are too short, people. If I ever get pissed off, I can just pick you up and hold you.
I will blow your fucking legs off.
You will try.
I'll bite your knees.
Because you specifically said that, you get another trait. Aggressive.
Oh, nice.
You basically got +1 to all initiative checks.
Jeez, that's really good, actually.
The way you RP will also give you shit. For example, in your case, given you actually tried to eat the rat, you got the fact that you're back.
You know, I was planning, before we started the session, for Vladdy to be like a little more calm and collected.
But you started.
Yeah, I much prefer the idea that he's a bit...
alcoholic.
Unhinged. I like
he's,
it.
He's a bit...
tweaked.
Yeah,
he's a bit
like out of it.
He's a bit fucked.
Yeah. A bit rushed.
Weirdly, I think you're gonna be the you know the soul
that
of the group.
Really,
you're gonna be
you
the guiding
him,
line.
You can ask him. It's not a good thing if I'm the guiding line in a group, but I will go for it. I will be Gerald.
Doing this.
You asked for it, boy.
No, I did not. I do not consent. So yeah, that's kind of your scene.
I thank you for all you have done to me. Your face is ugly, but your heart is golden. I will always remember you.
I'll just get out.
I don't know whether to be offended or complimented here.
Both sounds good.
Don't question it. We come in for a hug, yeah? And can we have like, I don't know, like Careless Whisper playing?
That's it.
Yeah, that's it. Yeah.
And it's gone.
Yeah.
That's copyright.
Exactly.
Imagine they fucking flagged you for that.
Oh, God.
They can't. It was like...
so off key.
Oh, yeah, like dude.
It's like shitty flute version.
Sticking it in your nose and playing it.
It just happens to be someone from like the DNC music group like watching. Got him!
Got him!
Fuck this man. Fuck him up. Take his kids. Take his wife.
Oh my god.
Alright, so Westwood, let's start with you. So yeah. You are brought in, you're instantly given psychic damage.
Mm.
You now have the trait migraine.
Oh, I suffer that in IRL, so I will live with that.
That's fucking sympathy.
It really does.
Yeah, that sucks. I've had a total of like 4 migraines in my entire life, and I hated every single one of them.
I don't get them often.
Passion.
Usually it's because of a sinus headache. I get them like right here, and I'll be like...
You love those migraines.
No, I hate them, but I'll take 2 of my heavy-duty painkillers, and I'll be loving the whole day.
Yeah.
Like, I'll just be like...
It's a bit zonked out.
Oh, yeah. Just if it's needed to be done.
I believe it. Like,
so, are me and Papa done?
Yeah, you are done.
Oh,
so, you have to almost smoke
on. Oh, no, that's not what I was planning to do.
Wait, can we just say his donk made me lose?
we'll be right back.
Yeah, I'm going to just go backstage.
We're going to go and something.
Watch the backdrop, people.
Yeah.
Thank you. So yeah, that's me and you for now.
Indeed. Alrighty.
As you're kind of being brought up, eventually it kind of takes you over to the armory, which technically could have used a map for, but given we're on time crunch, we're just trying to do speed. So yeah. It gives you an option of weapons as you find yourself now being surrounded by a whole arsenal, if you will.
Jeez. All right. My dude would probably go pick up a sword and shield. Sword and board. Straight up,
That's fine.
Unless there's anything special.
I'm gonna have to look you over. This will have to do for now. You are not of age to be given what your parents left you.
Parents? Left?
As you're kind of wielding them, you can now get the proficiency with them if you didn't already. And you kind of now have that as your constant thing. You can now pick a fighting style.
Ooh, from the fighter
subclass.
Okay, alrighty, I will...
If you want, roll a d4 and I'll pick one for you.
We'll do that. We'll choose the Baba Yaga, pick my fighting style for me, unless it's already... 2.
Champion fighter.
Hmm?
Champion fighter.
Ooh.
You basically crit on the 19 and then the 20.
Let's do this, boys!
Right.
Okay.
Fast forward to your educational state. You will roll me 4 intelligence checks.
1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, wait, in sequence or they can just...
Whatever.
Whatever, okay. 9 minus 2. 15 minus 2. 17 minus 2. And 14 minus 2. So a...
What are your two highest?
That would be a 13 and a 15.
So your 15 is the only one that counts. I will allow you to make that minus 2 or minus 1.
To my intelligence. That's okay. It makes me less dumb.
Yes.
I love it. To be honest, man, just to show you that you already know, it's a 7, yeah, so he just gives me 1.
Yeah, he just gives you 1. He makes you literate.
Ah, brilliant. My dad was trying to teach me this. Words mean something on paper.
You are the dumbest sack of shit I've ever had the misfortune to try and teach.
But you taught me. Better than them. Do they know how to read and write? 4 years. Yeah, 4 years.
They're trying to teach you how to fucking read. Want to know
the
read.
One thing that I learned? How to read and write.
You learned how to read and write.
And he gave me one intelligence point, so I now have minus 1.
There we go.
And do you ever call me a dig DM, I will remove that immediately.
How much intelligence do you have?
Eight. I now have 8 instead of 7.
He's basically Jamie Lannister, right? Yeah. Like, oh, I hate reading.
It makes reference to the end before.
After he kind of teaches you two and he sends you off, he kind of keeps him alone in the study.
For remedial classes.
Oh, crap. Yeah. I'm used to this by now. Yeah. Yes,
he kind of takes out this wrapped item in what seems to be like this black silk, and he just plops it on the table with a very large heavy tonk. This was something left to you by your father before you were put in here. He made me promise that I'd give it to you. I definitely haven't pawned it and had to rebuy it at some point.
Do I see a price tag on it?
Just quickly strikes
it off. Yeah, no.
Alrighty. I go up to it.
By all means.
It's a cool cloth, and I try to just pull the cloth away.
No, cloth.
Like, it's crazy. If you stab yourself.
It lands right on you.
12 plus... 14. I stab myself.
14, you said, right?
Yeah.
You're pretty lucky. You see it fall as it falls directly in between two of your toes. This extremely sharp point of this very delicately designed golden blade with hints of silver. This is your family sword. It is basically the equivalent of a think level 1 Holy Avenger. It is very, very weak. It's literally not Holy Avenger with that. It's the design of a Holy Avenger.
Okay.
It has essentially allows you to heal an additional 1d4 holy damage once per short rest.
Radiant or holy?
Radiant. That's radiant.
You deal holy damage.
Zing.
So, yeah.
Ooh, while we're in a bit of a lump, there's a bit of a Sim King interaction here. Matthew's been asked, if he's Canadian, does he know the secret handshake?
Yes.
No. You should have gone, no, wink.
They're Canadian, they can't lie.
We're not supposed to talk about that with foreigners.
Yeah, man. Yeah, not live. Come on, man.
We have evidence on stream now about this. Gosh. How, How am I going to get back into Canada?
They won't let you in. They won't let you in.
They want to deal with all the handshake.
My passport's going to disappear. It's a magical place, man. It just poofs those elves. Wait, no, I didn't say that.
What?
Someone say the elves?
Where?
On the last day, you're kind of now adorned with the sword at all times, I imagine.
Oh, yeah, for
and,
sure.
You kind of have your shield, which has slowly been upgraded over time, so you get plus one to AC. You basically have a better shield.
So instead of a plus two with a shield, I have a plus
three. Keep in mind, he's only gained one intelligence, a sword and a shield.
Hey, boys. I'm doing good. I mean, my character, I've made him to just be a frontline person. If I will hit, I will take hits.
That is the final day where I can offer you a final meal or some advice.
Okay, and I bring out a list for him. I want caviar, salmon, baked macaroni, and I just give out this.
He just like, instantly, just not even
slop. The list.
Fire bolts the entire thing and it cinders in your hand.
Man, I was really proud of that. I wrote that myself.
You gained the
chance. That was my homework. That took me a week.
That was my homework.
It was like a short list.
It was like four things.
Yeah, it was four.
Milk, eggs. It's just a shock.
Yeah, I wrote the wrong things.
And I can imagine the spelling, the handwriting.
Yeah, it's like chicken scratch. It's like primary school kid.
The G is backwards for some reason.
Why? Just give me the usual. Something to remind me of you. At least.
Oh.
Well, see what I'll whip up for you. We can go head out with the other.
Please, make sure it doesn't make me shit myself for a week like last time.
Look.
So no, I'm going to the watch, Papa.
I think keep in mind, I accidentally dropped one of my rats into the curry last week.
How was my... They looked the exact same.
One of them was rotten.
I could not...
I'm not a smart man.
We know this.
You gain trait, incontinent.
Gain trait, diarrhea.
Oh, please don't. My dude has migraines, no, man.
Gastrointestinal distress.
Actually, you gain the trait wary. Of the specifics for food. When it comes to food, you need to make sure that it's properly well done. You will kind of take small bites of it before you eat it. It's not going to kill. It's not as bad as the Dwarf of Dragonkind curse.
In a boat, Max. On a boat. I had to catch fish to live. Sorry, continue going.
Is this like for real?
No.
Oh, never mind.
I didn't.
You basically kind of like, you are very aware about food. You may not eat certain things when they're offered you by strangers, perhaps. Like if you meet a random NPC over the food.
It's like me, IRL.
You're going to be very, very wary.
To be honest, it's a really good thing to be. Shouldn't just eat food from strangers.
Yeah, and even like accepting drinks and party. Like, no,
like,
thank you.
You guys will be wary, but you will be extra wary.
Perfect. I'll just be like, okay, guys.
I don't need to be that wary, dude. I have iron gut.
Purify food and drink will always be prepared.
Don't worry about it, boys. I've got good berries.
Oh, yeah, is that just a good berry?
It's a really good berry.
There's strawberries out in his backyard.
Yeah.
He whacked me last time I took one.
Wow. Jesus. Whoa, I'll give you some. I'll give you some.
Ingrown peepee.
What? He's a dragonborn? Those things just straight up.
No, he's human.
What?
What?
Micropenis.
Oh.
Oh, no. Oh, no.
Never a noun had such a rebounding effect.
That's not something that got sucked in. That's just as it is.
I mean... I don't know, have you ever seen
that? Alright, hold on. Yeah, we're getting off topic. Yeah.
Moving on.
All of you, I want you out in the fighting pit now. And this is the point where I'll actually use the map.
The fighting
pit?
Are we
up
to fight
this one or this one?
This one.
I don't want to fight him.
This one?
Good folk.
Beautiful. We will put this, shall we say, here so they get to see it or no?
We really won't be able to see it much.
Sorry, guys.
I could now fuck that.
You bring it closer.
No, of course I need to move the eternal table.
Yeah, no, forget that.
So essentially, you guys can still position yourselves here. Just position yourself wherever.
I'm just by the door.
Wait, I know you're a ranged person.
Why is this even
more funny? Behind the wall and... No, fuck that. My dude doesn't give a shit.
Yeah.
This is 80% fog at this rate. Fuck. Alright, so, let's begin. The Papa Yaga kind of, like, goes up at the top of the stairs.
Papa.
Yes?
Do you intend for us to fight each other, my brothers?
Yes.
Oh, the dumb kid's ready. Yeah, you literally see my character just go, oh, this is gonna be good. Who wants to die
first? That is the Baba
Yaga. Hey, Baba. Papa.
Do I get to kill them?
Just maim them at best.
Jesus. So knock them the shit out.
Yes.
Alrighty. Who wants to die first?
Whoever's able to fix this up will be able to lead up in the Frozen North.
Oh, okay. So we're fighting for the position of leader?
That's correct.
Can we tastefully abstain?
What?
Oh my god.
No, I just didn't hear you.
May we tastefully disdain? I used the wrong word. Thank you. May we tastefully refrain from killing each other. Abstain from this.
Preferably.
No, don't kill us, but I will knock you out. If he tells me to as well to chase after you as you run,
Papa,
I will
do it. Do we have to wait to start, or can I use my bonus initiative to blow this motherfucker
in the face? For each minute that this goes on, I will add something to the pit.
Oh, Jesus.
I immediately take off. At that point, we know
Baba Yaga. I got a 17 plus 4.
19.
Shit.
You son of a monkey.
Fuck you guys. Yes. 16. My dude just shield and lay out, and I'm like, yes.
Okay. So, Papa, I imagine I go first. Okay. So, what I'm going to do, Papa, is I'm going to run at the paladin, but then suddenly dive off to the left, and then I'm going to use my bonus action as a
Wait,
goblin.
You run past me?
You have half covered.
No. No, I'm going to hide as a bonus action.
Bonus.
Okay. So, that is a total of. Only an 11 stealth, but I'm going to.
I see.
Move. I'm going to remove myself from there until you tell me. So.
And you're done.
I end my. Actually, I'm going to hold an action, Papa.
Mm-hmm.
From my hidden position, if someone seems to see me and walk towards me before they get within 5 feet, I'm going to shoot an arrow at them.
All means you do that.
Cool.
So with my 11 passive perception,
who's next?
I know you're there.
So my roll is 21. 21.
Next.
Yeah, 11. I'm next. I think actually it might be 20 plus 3, plus 3, plus 2,
how many
plus
did you
1.
Get?
It's 21 now, it's 21.
Why did I get 16? Oh, I got 16. I'm last.
That's basically we're going that.
Mm-hmm. You're next, yeah.
I would like to spawn an Eldritch Cannon.
You fucker.
Sure.
No, I believe it is at a 5 foot range.
Yep.
Then I'm going to put. Oh, hello, little man. It is a flamethrower.
Quick question, do you want to hold it or not?
I am not going to hold it.
Okay.
I'm going to put it over here.
You little.
And I'm just going to leave it there. And I'm going to hide behind it. Maybe I cast shield next round. Who knows? Bonus action, I take a swig of vodka.
Roll. Free action. You don't have to roll anything. Okay. Next.
So I saw little one run around the side, and with my 11 passive perception, I know he's trying to hide behind there.
Yep.
And I see him spawn out a machine, which I've known. He's probably tried to murder me a few times with already.
It typically just makes it crawl in your bed in the middle of the night to hear you scream. You grab the turret, arachnophobia, no.
Alrighty then, I am going to... I'm very sorry about this, my friend. He's the only one in front of me, and I run towards you. 5, 10...
May I ask something? Can I activate the turret on the round of spawning it?
Because
he's in a 15-foot cone right there.
I would say it's behind the wall, isn't it?
No.
It's a bonus
action.
It's peeking behind.
It's peeking. Oh, what the fuck was that?
Don't worry.
It's a protein shake.
Don't worry. Protein shake.
Okay, so yeah, I would say you are able to if you want to.
Do it.
Yeah?
Yep.
Oh, nice.
Do it.
I'm going to flame the paladin.
Okay.
So that's 2d8, I think.
Do I get to roll a dex
save?
Yeah,
dex save. Oh, hit me with the dex save.
No. My dex, at least, is a plus 2, which is cool as shit.
Oof, okay. 8.
How much damage do you do?
Oh, it's only 4.
Nice.
Take 4 points of
damage. My migraines hurt more than that.
Oh, fuck. God, he is stupid, but he is strong.
And at that point, I chase at you.
Oh, God. God.
And I have the greatest reason to, because you set my gorgeous looks. And
you were about to come for me anyway, boy.
I will.
Attack roll?
I wish I could shove you first, but I'm not gonna. I'm just gonna whack you.
Yep. Hit me with a sword.
I'm gonna whack you with my holy sword. Not doing the radiant damage, it's normal. Fine, whack. Is it a long sword, basically?
It's a long sword.
Okay.
Oof. Poor old.
Into the wall. 3 plus, like, 5.
Mm. You go to swing as you are, he is able to quickly kind of like hit you.
I don't need to do anything. I am much shorter than you think.
You really are.
But today sorry, I decided not to.
Today.
Max, just clarify. What armor do I have?
You would basically, as a ranger, have leather. Thick leather.
Leather? Okay, so it's 11. So my AC is 15.
It's a leather.
So just to let you know, Max. Mm-hmm. Protection plus 1 AC. I have 16 because of the dex. I have 3, and I have 20 AC at the moment. Just to let you know. Okay.
Good to know. So don't hit him with actual physical. Oi, oi, oi.
Hold on.
Metagame. Right. Metagame, excuse me.
If it is my turn, I am going to
flank him.
Poke my head out from back here. I'm going to come back. So, where you're standing, I'm going to come out from beneath you.
Would you rather not be fighting with Dunbar?
Shut up, Papa. That's what I do. Up. Nice. Knock an arrow.
Got line of sight there?
Yep.
Should just do. Hit the cauldron. Oh, no.
Of who?
Of you, of you. You're back. You can see your back.
Shooting me. You why little.
Actually, why little, little guys got to stick together.
You little. I'm going to murder you.
Actually, oh.
Oh.
Yeah, it was about to go. Okay, but I was going to say as a bonus action, I would like to cast Hunter's Mark on him. But I miss, so I'm guessing, like, whatever. Doesn't
you
matter.
Kind of hit as you're shooting, you did not take into consideration the girth of the cauldron, of the pestle that the Baba Yaga's in.
I see.
It just wedges itself inside.
Nah. Okay, I'm going to use the rest of my movement then. I've used my action and bonus action, so. 10, 15, 20, 25. I'm going to move out here.
So we just hear a ding, and they just...
exactly that. Okay. Exactly that.
Okay.
Hitting you, sorry.
Don't worry about it.
All right, Alex.
My go?
Yep.
Does my Eldritch Cannon make a move regardless of...
It's on your bonus action. You activate it as your bonus action. It can move 15 feet.
Uh-huh.
It can crawl on surfaces.
Uh-huh.
And
can
it... Yeah, it has...
Crawl on surfaces?
I think...
Like a wall? It's a fucking turret? Okay,
it's a turret, man.
I know it's a turret, but it's like
a... I have a feeling I'm going to have to make a tech tree for your turret, aren't
I mean, amongst other things.
Oh, God.
Amongst other things. Artillery is a good word to use. So...
Sure you want to do this, friend?
Well, I have no choice. Papa wants us to fight.
That is true.
I am going to use my level 1 spell slot to cast my level 1 artillery spell, Thunder Wave.
That will hit you too.
Thunder
Wave.
Why would it hit you?
You can pick the box.
It's gonna hit my
that's the worst spell ever.
In my bonus action, I'd like him to be flaming him while he gets Thunder Waved.
Okay.
Fuck.
Sure. I get 2 dex saves.
What does Whelm do that does thunder something?
Thunder... Spank or something.
Crack or whatever the
that's the one I thought he was referring to, Jesus.
No, Thunder Wave. If you like, I can pull up its stats.
Nah,
it's a very low level spell.
I'm very, very scatterbrained.
That's okay.
It's fine. Thunder Wave. Okay. So he rolls a dexterity saving throw for Thunder?
Yep, so 2 dex saves.
2 dex saves.
Alright, roll me 2 dex saves.
Please be bad.
Let's see.
Making the paladin roll dex saves.
Clever. Ooh, 4 and a 9. God.
Like total 4 and 9?
Yep.
No, well, like plus bonuses, but not
6
very high.
And an 11.
So let's see what Turret Boy does first.
Okay.
Ooh.
Ooh.
14.
14. Turret does 2d8.
That's pretty
good.
God. 35 minus 14.
Burn!
You feel concerned, everyone?
Yeah, everyone's concerned. This both Papa and
Chico
back there doing the hands.
Mm-hmm.
Thunderwave does how much damage?
Thunder Wave deals 1d8?
Just 1d8?
3d8.
3d8?
I can look it up.
Pretty sure it's 3d8.
Not sure.
I'm about to get
it. Might be
2.
I think it's
blasted into the back of the wall.
Thunder. Oh, Thunderclap is the one also in roll, I think. Thunder.
Thunder Wave is 2d8.
It's
and 2D8. One extra every level.
Ah, okay, that's where I got the 1D, 3D8 from.
Another 14.
Jesus.
Yeah.
Fuck.
Brutal. 28, man, like nothing.
So back to my turn.
Does Thunder Wave knock him back?
It does. I think it knocked me prone to.
In addition, unsecured objects that are completely within the area of effect are automatically pushed 10 feet away from the spell effect. The spell emits a thunderous boom audible up to 200 feet.
5, 10.
21 minus 14, boys. Now,
my.
I have 7 HP.
Oof. My turret. Obviously takes a blast too.
Well, technically you
your
could
turret
well,
dies.
No, 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 hold on a second. Because you could face it that way and pff, that way and hit him. But
it's
not
a cube.
It's got 15
yeah,
HP.
It's a cube.
It's got 15 HP because it's 5
survives
times.
With one hit.
It survives with
oh
one
God.
Hit point. And it looks at
sparks
me.
Everywhere.
Daddy, why?
Daddy, why?
Daddy, why?
Daddy, why?
Let's just go and step on it.
Okay, Daddy. Why are you talking to me?
Okay.
Yeah, because I go 24.
Well, I can't use my movement, can I? Mm. No, I've used my actions first. I don't have mobility.
I will say that you do if you want.
Oh, nice. I'm out of here. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, yeah, I think I'm just going to make myself as difficult to get to as possible.
Okay.
5, fuck it. That way I'm in line of sight of him still, but I'm not in line of sight of Seb.
Okay.
You are a gnome. You know you have 25 feet, right? Just to let you know.
Yeah, wasn't that 25
feet? Yeah, it was. I'm just reminding you.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, fuck.
Just reminding you.
I know, I know, I know, I know.
You can't get away from me, bitch.
I'm not, stop pretending like you're Twitch at.
That is true.
Speaking of which.
Oh.
Baba, they're ganging up on me and I don't like this.
It's cause.
Oh, Perry, you pussy.
Why, fuck yeah.
Told the world about the Canadian secret handshake. He's freaking out.
The Canadian, I think.
Yeah, I think so. Imagine the Canadian Secret Service kicked in his door. Like, what are you talking about? Talk about this. Get in there. Stop resisting.
Handshake me. Do it now. Alright, so.
My turn.
Turn was.
He's coming. The paladin's very upset. All your smites. I want all your smites. All together.
Sadly, he only has one smite to give.
It's enough.
Yeah, because like one hit and I'm out, basically. Yeah. Unless
you
like.
You can lay off hands yourself.
I know, because at this point.
You could also take cover and like, go outside.
I am going to go 5, 10, 15, disappear from view from you guys in a way. Because technically,
yeah.
I am.
So the last,
cover behind
the last
you.
Point you, saw you.
Yep. I just go like that and I go, and I pump myself up with full 15 points of healing from 50? My. 15.
Oh, God. You're full lay on hands. Yeah, yeah.
7
please.
Plus 15 equals 22. No. Yes.
So.
I have 22 HP. But I don't have a. Bonus action, Shield of Faith. It will do nothing for dexterity save. Actually.
Okay.
It'll do nothing for dexterity saving throws, will it?
Nope.
Shield of Faith gives you extra 2 AC. Which is good. I mean, nothing
yeah.
to scoff at.
Okay.
Yeah. Oh my good.
I
baby.
Am so happy I'm not in that room.
Good lord, no, baby, no.
No, baby.
Oh, I'm not happy with that.
This is flashbacks to your dream of bears with X's.
Oh, God.
Oh my God, it's a bear with an X.
I'm quite bored of this Hans deal with them. And out of nowhere, from a rafter above, a giant werebear just lands in the middle.
But where's the bear?
Oh, am I making, really? What do I take?
I'm gonna be nice.
I'm gonna be nice.
Make 4 points of psychic damage.
4 points of psychic damage, I'll take it. Thank you, Daddy.
Okay. I'm uncomfortably erect. Moving on.
Let's go.
Okay, is it my turn?
Oh, yes, it's your turn. You suddenly see this giant werebear wielding an axe. Oh!
What the hell is that thing?
That's Hans.
thank you for
Hans.
Clarifying. Can I kill Hans, Papa?
You can maim him.
Oh.
But he will kill you.
Alright, I take a shot at Hans.
Oh, nice. Thank you for pulling him off me.
That's a 23. Did you hit?
23 hits.
Since I have my Colossus Slayer. Oh no, he hasn't taken damage yet, eh? No, wait, is it?
Yeah, which one's it takes?
No, I think it's. No, it's against people who are bigger than me. No,
it was called. Everybody.
Yeah, exactly. And since I'm a goblin, people
wow,
are bigger than me.
I wonder why you picked the goblin.
I get an extra 1d8.
That's really good, actually.
That's
actually
good. Well done.
Like, legit, yeah.
No,
like,
but I
want to
see what mine
picked a small character. Would have been even better if you were like tiny.
so then you can murder him. Really.
Oh, wow, 7 and 8. Damn, damn. That was like 15 damage.
Damn. Oh, then, these things are rocking these 7s
then,
today.
Right?
Spit flying
then I'm going to run 5, 10, 15, 20. I'm going to hide. Bonus action. Hide. Hide from the werebear.
I smell a pussy.
It's 15.
All right. It is now the werebear's turn because I actually rolled for its initiative.
Oh dear. He's not coming to me, right? He just got shot in the back.
How much did you roll from your stealth?
15. But I'm if you notice, I'm outside the house. Like, look, I'm all the way back here.
Actually, there is you right next to him.
I am behind
a wall. He's behind a wall, technically.
There is a wall.
He's going to roll to sniff.
Right there.
He's going to sniff.
Sniff here.
Which one of you has shat your pants more?
Are you serious? Are you asking this?
Doesn't he have chronic diarrhea?
I got bloody to shit, so I smell like blood.
Yeah. Like, he smells cooked meat.
He just turns toward, move the miniature and turn him towards him.
Me?
Yeah.
You mother... There's a wall.
There's a wall in the way.
There's a wall. Through the wall. He's gonna grab his axe.
Oh yeah? Oh, that's dope.
plus 5 through. AC for cover.
I'm just pumping myself with HP and also...
He rolled a natural 20.
Wow, okay.
Are you serious?
So he breaks the wall.
I have 22 AC.
He rolled a natural 20.
He smashes the wall.
He smashes the remains of the wall as he hits you, no doubt. How much is your total AC? I'll be nice.
22.
He just meets your AC with a natural 20. As there is debris and an axe winging through this wall.
I imagine I'm wiping my face because I'm like, oh
Jesus Christ. Bro, fuck me. You take a total.
I will die.
You take 8 plus 2, so 10 points of damage.
God damn it. And back an down additional to 12.
From the debris, 4 points of damage.
Does he take any damage from the debris?
No!
God damn it, I went back down to my 8 HP. I throw my sword and I just go, fuck you, Baba. I just start walking. I'm like, fuck this shit. No, at the moment.
It's not his turn.
It's not my turn. Think about it.
Okay.
I'm gonna be nice and see if he doesn't have multi-attack. Okay.
He can't move away from me if he feels like.
No!
Next is me.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Keep in mind, there's no wall there.
Mm. No. And also... No, technically only the werebear is in the 15-foot cone.
Brother Gerald. Do I see it through the...
Yes.
Brother Gerald goes pussy for son! Ding, ding!
And by the way, I saw this through a crack in the wall and I go, oh my god! Oh my god! I just see a fucking axe through the wall!
Yeah, I imagine I lock eyes with him like, wait...
Oh my god. You just see like a tiny pebble come by your foot.
So Vladislav is very upset as having seen his brother hit by disgusting bear man.
You hit me twice.
You came rushing at me, bro.
After you flamethrowered me.
At that point, it was just us v us. We had a job.
That is true.
Now that bear is fucking you up. I don't appreciate it.
Yeah, man, I don't know this bear.
Oh, fuck this bear.
He was like a random montage of him scrubbing you guys down.
Can I see him get deck saved?
He's scheming like he's been with us the whole time.
He's just the one reference.
But he was never a bear.
The thing is, the Papa Yaga would disguise him to make him look like him, but no one ever found out.
Dude, I'm fucking
we couldn't bear with the thought.
I feel so bad. It's my brother as well, and I'm just like...
We just never knew.
None of you ever knew this.
None of us ever knew.
Oh, man.
He bathed us, he clothed us.
He bathed us.
He cooked for you.
He cooked for us.
Regardless, can he make a dex save? Because he's in a flamethrower.
Can you make a
dex save? He's in a flamethrower.
He rolled a natural 6.
So he fails it.
Whether
or not he fails it, my Eldritch Cannon flamethrower does have a clause that stipulates it sets fire to any flammable object.
That's where it's like with flammable.
And then we go. 6 damage, but he's on fire.
Ah!
Alrighty. As good a time as any to ask. My thunder cannon, does it have ammunition?
It's auto. Like it always has ammunition.
Oh, I thought you meant it was auto. I am... lick them with thunder.
I am concentrating at the moment.
If you want to use...
How did you throw an 8 there?
Archery.
Basically, one thing that I like to do with thunder cannons... sorry, I'm still going to send my pause again.
Mm-hmm.
You can basically spend an action to shoot, a bonus action to shoot again, but then you can't use it next turn because it has to recharge.
Oh, that's okay. A couple of quick shots?
Yeah.
Hmm. Sounds good to me. Sounds good to me. What's the range on this bad boy?
60 feet.
Oh, it fires slugs. I'm going to make two attacks. Right. One attack, one bonus. Oh.
Mm.
Does 14 hit?
Hmm? You miss me too.
As it, as you shoot and it gets into its now on fire hide, it melts. The bullet melts.
Wow, that was
he gets a +1 to his AC.
Napalm, man. Oh my God.
Stop making fucking bullets out of tin, maybe.
Yeah.
Second hit is an 18.
Hit.
Damn. And that's a 1d12. So watch, as it is superior to the 2d6s. It's a 9.
That's a 6. That's one. That's 1d6.
It's a 9.
No, it's a 9.
Oh, it's a 9? Yeah. Oh, I thought it was a 6. Yeah. My apologies.
So pretty good. Alright, so you managed.
It's not superior to 2d6s. I mean, minimum 2 is far superior.
Yeah.
Plus, it's always fun rolling more than one die.
Agreed.
You know, clapping him
okay, out. So how much do you roll damage-wise?
9. Oh, plus my dex?
Yeah, plus dex.
Oh, it's 12.
Alright, both so are ranged, so
I
won't shove them.
I love it. I like the idea.
You
You're a self-healing tank who gets supported by an artillery and a ranger.
Great. So you're going to start exploding shit whilst I'm in
no,
it.
No, I explode the shit that's coming.
Alright, just get me a way to like get better deck saves and we'll be good with fireballing me.
I ask my Eldritch Cannon...
Can't you add your charisma to save, or is that later?
Later. That's when I get an aura.
Yeah, yeah.
What about my Eldritch Cannon sits on your back and flames the fuck out of anyone trying to flank you?
You want, if your guy comes up and starts crawling on me, I'm not going to do anything because at the moment I'm looking at a bear.
Oh, no,
and my
mean,
head
I
is.
I mean, in general.
In general? put
plunk
it on my
plunk.
Head.
Yeah, plunk it.
Like, seriously, literally, plunk that thing on me and I'll. There is also one of them, as you can know, it's a protector. It literally gives
yeah,
temp HP
it,
constantly.
Yeah,
it's just like.
It. It's pretty dope.
And it's every
that's
single time in
that's
this
what I'm
refresh.
You got tank up there. Take the hits.
Okay, my turn, right? I
yeah,
think.
It's your turn.
Big bear, he's wielding an axe. Okay.
Caress him sensually.
Oh, it's either command and I tell him to throw his weapon away or it's just I put my sword in my sheath as a free action and I go, command, give me your weapon, please.
What's the save?
It's a I have 14, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 12.
It's fucking hilarious.
He makes it.
Oh.
Really?
It's a shame. I was going to say, it's fucking hilarious.
That's right.
This guy on fire calms down. Oh yeah. Still burning.
I tried.
You tried.
Bonus action?
I'm a paladin.
Like, wink.
I bonus action, I go, hey man, can you hit someone else?
Hey, I didn't set you on fire.
Yeah, look at the guy behind you.
He just put a bullet in the back of your fucking head.
They killed me. You want to kill them together? Like,
hey.
Yeah, pretty good.
I think, I think we have to take into account the intelligence of your character. And like sometimes, like even that command, I was thinking a little bit.
Too high up?
Maybe. I don't know.
Just asking him to disarm himself.
Than actual intelligence, though.
Say again?
Like you've been trained to an extent, so it would be something that he learned.
He is a military man.
Mm-hmm. I play chess with 7 intelligence.
You don't have 8. alright, so. Jesus Christ, Westwood. Alright, so.
My turn?
It is now your turn.
Okay.
As it goes after you.
So I can see through this, like, gap in the wall, I'm guessing.
Gap.
Yes.
The gap.
Gap.
Okay. So I'm seeing my brother getting eaten by a bear.
Mm-hmm.
Does the bear look kind of rough?
No,
at all?
This bloody. He's
bloody? Okay.
Fireball.
Yeah, sure. I'm going to take a shot at the.
Get
it!
Watch out!
Shoot her!
Oof. That is a 13. No, 12. 12? No, 13. Does a 13 hit? No?
13 does not hit.
No. Then I miss. I'm going to go, and I'm a bonus action, hide again. That's a pretty good one. That's like
you
a 20, 24.
Oh, hiding like a motherfucker.
Watch out.
He's gone.
Alright. He's back into the walls. Alright, so it's now the bear's turn.
Okay.
He's going to see you, but he's also going to see the little shit.
That's me.
No, the turret.
Oh no! He's only got 1 HP!
He pisses in its general direction. Yep, he hits the turret. It's
what was that roll?
That was a 19.
Oh damn, it's got 18 AC.
Yeah, it's got really high AC, hasn't it, man?
Pretty
it's
good.
Brilliant.
That either that is technical a bonus action, just stomps it with his foot.
Oh, yeah. Technically a bonus action by tits.
So
I'm not fighting the DM, not fighting the sorry.
You fucking what, mate?
Sorry.
You what?
Nothing. Nothing. Bonus action. Great move.
All right. So, for 16 to hit you, he does not hit you.
22, baby.
You manage to kind of parry it with your sword as he tries to swing at you again. And that's the end of his turn. Alex, go.
I'm up. I don't have much. I throw a bottle of vodka at him to attempt to make the flames even worse.
Ooh.
In fact, no, I already used my spell slot. Never mind.
You have multiple spell slots.
At third level, I only have one level one spell slot. And catapult is a level one spell slot.
Cannot be.
Dude, you get three. You have at least three, man.
I catapult a bottle of vodka into the back of his head.
What?
I'd like to have a dex save on that bad boy.
14 plus
12. Yeah, three. 4 infusions known, 2 infused items, 2 cantrips.
How much is your save?
Say again?
How much is your save?
My spell save?
Yes.
Not great, it's only 13.
He does make the save, so I'm gonna say that kind of flies by his ear and it lands. Roll me a dexterity saving throw.
Oh, damn.
Oh, seriously? I'm so sorry, my dude.
He's right in the line of fire. Come on.
It's true. That's your
can I make mail?
No.
Nice.
Please, I just catch it.
Save the vodka. Smash
now you see
it.
Me just go. Oh.
You get plus 5. Plus 5 temporary HP from the vodka.
Nice.
Really?
Because you got a natural 20.
Nice. Why not?
I rewards a natural 20. Shit happens when it's a natural
20. Oh, that's great. So just. Natural Lovia. I'm just going like this.
Could have gone halfling for lucky.
That's true. Alright, so yeah. With that, it is now
my turn?
Yes.
I want. May I whack?
Sure.
Okay. Because at this point. Oh, dear God. Yep.
Oof. 7 plus 5. 12.
12. You don't hit.
Don't hit. Nope.
I'm really impressive. Sucking today, Baba.
You kind of like go to swing as he kind of like hits you off with his axe. So that's the end of your turn.
Jesus.
So I pop my head out from over here.
It's me.
Take a shot at the bear. That's a fucking 6 plus 8. 14. Does a 14 hit?
No.
Oh my God.
We're
gonna die.
I run back over here.
As this occurring before you can have another turn.
Oh my, oh jeez, it's a bunch of sentient chains.
Does it grapple him?
Baba Yaga essentially kind of like summons these chains to quickly grab the bear. Enough! All of you, come forward. Kind of like quickly conjures water to douse the bear as he then proceeds to let him out of the chains and the bear is now left free.
Have you got any healing? I know you have healing.
Oh, you pussy.
They hurt me really badly. You saw it. They didn't even hit each other.
So yeah, kind of bullied this.
Yeah, it's because he's tall. He's an easy target, isn't it?
I roll me 4d4.
Oh, God. Okay.
Him and his man.
4, legs. 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13.
You heal up 13 plus 4.
Valid, the normal legs. Look at me, I have fully articulated leg joints.
17, yeah, you heal up 17. Yes.
I know.
I have 5 toes on each of my feet.
Whoa, normally.
5, 6, 7, 8. So I have 25, 8.
How many toes does a gnome have?
25.
How many toes you got, mate?
Hey, you've got
5. No, I have 5.
Oh, but it is disappointing.
All the distance, it always, the image is a bit blur.
This was a lesson in futility. There are fights that you are going to take, but you cannot win. Is that clear enough? The world around you can, as I've taught you, be your undoing and also your hiding place. But you also need to consider that you at first attacked each other just simply because I told you to do so.
Well,
you did bring us here with the explicit intent and telling us that we are to fight each other.
None of you questioned why.
Papa, we have been trained for combat. You even told us that the winner would be designated the leader to take us up to the branch.
I would have not listened to him. I'll be honest.
To be honest, I didn't really want to
fight. Beat the shit out of me? No offense. Put you two together and you come up to my height, maybe.
Well, that's a good idea.
Big clock for a man who almost dropped.
Yeah. Who took every single hit from that bear?
Whose fault
enough.
Is that?
He kind of like slams his pestle.
We've got good brother synergy, I'm going to say that.
We're just arguing constantly.
What I am trying to tell you is sometimes you will need to make decisions, but you also need to question the logistics behind them. You will need to question if this is the right call. There cannot be one leader. What?
I never learned what the word logistic means.
You gained a trait, disappointed father.
Oh.
Listen, my dude isn't very smart. I was just thinking.
Actually, you don't get that trait because you don't understand what disappointment is.
Oh. Oh, hold on. Wait a minute. Oh. I definitely know what this... He would have probably...
Intelligence, I would...
Bro.
It's not even a trait.
Fine. It was a power. It was a 14 minus 1. It was 13.
Roll that Pepto-Bismol.
Yeah. That's cocked. That's super cocked. That's super cocked.
Mega cocked. Come on.
Oh. Yeah. No. Yeah.
How much?
So 2.
You don't understand the feeling of disappointment.
That's great, what? Though. That's yeah. awesome. That's nice. A really what? Cool trait. You think my family was ever sad? Well, probably they were. Why don't you give him the trait
eternal optimist?
you know, if he could,
his legs are being eaten. It's a great
If he couldn't feel disappointment, he'd be essentially immune to a number of magical effects. He wouldn't be able to be despaired or angered.
You can't be feared, though.
Yeah.
I don't think.
I guess that's a separate.
But it isn't technically under discipline.
Yeah, no. You don't live. Yeah. It's hope. It's the opposite.
Yeah.
I forgot I had my channel divinity.
Well,
hey guys, I played a paladin before.
Papa, go up there.
Believe me, I do understand the lesson that you preach about in this this little scenario. But
shut the fuck up.
With respect, you say a fight you could not win, but you ended it early.
One of your own is about to die. I had the insert name of bear, which I forgot.
Hans.
I gave Hans strict orders to not attack you as fast as he could.
Well, might be fine of you to send up a bear at us, though.
He is a nice bear.
Indeed.
Has he always been in the house? I feel like he's a really close family. He feels close nothing. Family friend.
He has always been around. He sees you when you're sleeping. He knows when you're awake.
Is his name Bernstein?
No.
Does he have a hot pot of porridge or something?
No. He has aided me around the house, I will say that.
I do not understand this cultural reference of Bernstein.
Oh, no, do I.
It's a noble thing, you wouldn't understand. It's for the higher up people.
Psh, whatever.
We're hearing that a lot.
Hey, I hate those people too, to be honest. I'm more with you guys. I've lived with you guys for like, 18 years now or some shit?
In my head, I imagine you, like, I'm like you lounging as you say that. I'm more with like you guys and holding out an empty glass for me to take away.
Well, at the moment, my character's dead.
Take it.
He takes the vial and just like...
He's actually holding up your bottle of vodka for you. He's like, take.
Oh, no. My character's like, you fucking almost killed me, man.
Regardless, you will all go rest. In morning, you make way. This is clear. This will be the last time that we will officially be able to spar together.
We're going to fight you.
No. I do not wish to hurt any of you.
Mumble.
Whoa.
I mumbled something.
Give it a month or something.
He rolled an insight check. He rolled a 17.
What was your mumble?
You can't insight my mumble. Perception my mumble?
Okay. Rolled even higher on the perception.
Hit me.
19.
Should have taken sleight of hand when I was offered it. I mumbled something. I said, well, lucky for us, eh? Boys, the old papa with... Well, you perceptioned by mumble.
Deception check.
Oh, deception check. Oh, fuck.
Dude.
As well?
Yeah.
It's
like,
the same one.
Like, yeah.
Do I add my proficiency
god,
bonus
exactly
so I don't
the
have
same
skill? I don't have the proficiency bonus.
Yeah,
and
it's a double-sided as well.
Oh
my god.
17?
It's
the same sky.
What the absolute shit.
Yeah. With a 17, he pulled really high. So you're going to tell me what you said, or am I going to force it out of you?
He's drunk.
Yes.
A lot.
He's always drunk.
Exactly.
It's part of his appeal.
But you're not that wrong.
Metagame, I had nothing in my mind for saying. I literally just said mumble for the comedic effect. there was nothing. He said nothing. I didn't say mumble. I said mumble.
Okay, fuck it. Moving on. Okay, you guys are kind of left to your own devices. You can rest, you can keep training if you want, if I'm getting any more bonuses at this rate. But essentially, this is basically to show you that there isn't really one captain role.
You guys need to make group decisions. You need to understand that there can't be just one person that's going to lead the pack. Okay?
No. We thus communist.
That was me out of character. Well, that's fine. As you guys rest, morning comes, and you guys are basically hearing the sound of church bells ringing. The lot of you. Oh, fuck, Russian. The lot of you. It's time to get up.
Wait a minute. Just finishing my prayers.
Ned! Just walk away.
And done.
You're getting your HP in check, so if you lost any spells,
you keep your rest. Faith.
Are you okay?
Yep.
Yeah. Okay. What's that noise?
As him slowly gargling on his own God knows what.
No, I'm done.
Fucking hope so. You guys are let out of the Baba Yaga hut. The Baba Yaga's chicken legs kind of go down, letting you guys out. Now suddenly, so you see before you a large what?
Baba Yaga's chicken legs.
Oh my god! I forgot we're in a Baba Yaga's hut.
Baba Yaga's chicken legs. Yeah, he knew it.
Yeah, Baba Yaga's chicken legs.
At first, I thought it sounds like a menu item. You know, like, yeah. Like come down, get some Baba Yaga's chicken legs.
But then you imagine, like, he takes off the pestle and he's got beautiful girl
and that's
legs.
That's the second thought I had, and I'm like, we didn't see his legs before in the pestle. Dude skips leg day every day. He's got these chicken legs. You know what I'm saying? I'm sorry. Beautiful.
That's so bad.
Okay, to see that. Elevated, it's true. Just gets off the peasant,
lifts off of the peasant.
On this special occasion, I will finally walk. Oh my gosh.
He's
got a gluttonous rear. No, that's not canon. I refuse, that is not canon. As you guys are kind of led out into the courtyard, you are seeing like a pathway with a lot of people kind of cheering you off, like trying their best to hand you things, clothes, clothes.
Thank you, Marjorie. Hey, careful of that hip. No walking down the steps of the church. Got to take the ramp, you know what I'm saying?
I would like to
perceive. Love to the kids.
For the best looking quality of food for my brother. He is very picky when it comes to eating. It's a 19 on my perception.
You basically managed to find like the baker who's prepared like this giant tray of like bread rolls for you guys to go on.
Thanks for the tray.
Gerald, you can have the bread. As you well know, I
perfect,
will eat
and I go and I take the tray from him. Just the whole tray.
Yeah, me too.
So with my perception...
Point, that's my only one.
With my perception of 19 plus...
My character's lost for the tray in his hand.
Perception,
no, Papa,
intelligence?
Kind of pushes you
no, wisdom.
Wisdom, okay. So with 21, do I see anything else of use to us?
With 21, you kind of see like winter clothes, which you guys don't really have a lot of. Oh, you dope. Kind of like snatch those.
I could get in a sock.
Huh?
I can get in a sock, probably. I'm a small guy, right? You know, big
you're
winter
not
sock.
That small.
I mean, I'm not talking like this small, yeah. You know what I'm saying? A big
you're
sock.
You're the equivalent of...
Think about like a like one of the Christmas stockings.
Yeah, maybe like a werebear's sock or something. Yeah. You know?
Okay.
Okay, so we load up on some winter clothes. Winter clothes, gentlemen.
How big
winter
is
clothes.
How big is the tray for the food? Is it like that?
Yeah.
Oh.
Is that a shield?
Technically.
Oh, it's a sled.
Oh, shit.
I just go... Sure, I'll bring you back the tray. Here's a... Can I change some of my money? Because I don't want to give him a gold. I'm a noble. I'd have to give him a gold.
It's gifts, no? They're giving us gifts. Yeah.
Don't give him fuck, I don't give a shit. I'll take
the you fucking... Yeah, you're damn right you give me a
bread. I'll pay you back someday, friend.
Very well. Please do not bend the tray.
Okay, winter clothes, anything else?
She's not giving
winter
that tray
clothes, fine booze, like they give you guys whiskey. It will be something that basically will able to heat you up whilst you're up there.
Okay. Every firewood. Single bottle we pick that up for him.
Do we have any kind of...
Notes.
Do we have mounts?
Okay, so we have winter clothes. We have a tray of bread.
Fucking bread.
We have how many whiskey bottles?
Five.
Times five, uh-huh.
And lastly, you are all finally given a sack of wood.
What, you mean my trousers?
No.
Ba-dum-ts.
I have to say, I have a question. Are these sacks of wood relative to our sizes? Because, like, how big is my sack?
I carry their sacks.
It would be the equivalent.
I hold and cradle their sacks and make sure everything is needed and not unnecessary stuff, because you should always check if there's unnecessary stuff
true.
In the sack.
It's true. Oh yeah, wood lice and stuff.
There's like a dead squirrel.
There's a dead squirrel. I toss it over to the opportunist of this dead squirrel.
Fuck yeah! It doesn't even like leave the
air. Lovely. You know, they let loose a real nice like smell when you burn a pine cone. It's nice to have a pine cone in the sack sometimes. A sack of wood.
Yeah. You basically have enough wood to last you a month in the sack.
Nice.
In the sack.
Yes. This nice and leathery sack.
Mm. I've got wood to last me a month in the sack. Nice.
I'm just eating the bread.
I made the same joke, but your timing was just better, man. As a Christian, I'm like, oh, enough wood for a month.
Christmas tree in my ass.
God,
I think I can close
this. Alright, you actually will be using that soon. That one specifically, I can close the rest.
Okay.
We can close this one?
Or this is the one
we're going to be using soon?
No, that's the only one we're going to be using, because that's the cabin.
In the wood?
Can we call it a bitchin' ass cabin?
Can we call it a love shack instead?
The love
shack. Yeah, bingo, that's exactly thinking B-52s.
Yeah, put that there. I'm just making sure that
they're the right ones.
Yeah.
Bear with us, chat. Again, this is very bare minimal shit. We took 2 hours to set up today, and it was a bitch. Of course, we had to rely on this mic again, for fuck's sake. After the stream, someone tell me how I can return shit.
Just hit him up. Literally, just go on the customer service.
Set up a shrine to Jeff Bezos.
Daddy Bezos, hit us up.
So wait, you guys both walk slow, don't you? No, you're
no.
good.
25 feet.
I've picked him up. He's on my shoulders. I am not walking at a slower pace.
Retaining calories is very important to growing body.
Roll me a flex check.
Flex check. Natural one.
In the train.
You poop a little bit.
Natural one.
Wow,
you know
that was double one.
You know what?
This is meant to be.
You know what? I'm just aggressive enough.
Oh
to burn my flex check.
Burn your one inspiration, which carries over between sessions.
Oh shit, for real? I fuck it. 13, motherfucker!
It's okay, it's there. It's
do I add my strength bonus?
Yeah.
15, motherfucker!
You have a +2 to your strength.
Yeah, dude.
He's got no low stats.
I've got no low stats. I'm a very highly capable young man.
I have an 8 in my intelligence.
I'm so sorry, Winston.
It's okay, I played. Played a smart character.
You guys begin making your way up as you finally reach the hill. The Papa Yaga kind of is like, this is where we break a... Oh, fuck, I'm turning Russian again. This is where we're finally going to be breaking our paths.
I did it to Patrick every session.
I'm going to miss you.
My Russian.
Can I see your legs?
He kind of begins pushing himself up as you see this withering mass of tentacles.
Stop, and I push him down.
Like, he sinks
Stop. Oh, wait, does he sink into the pot?
He sinks into the pistol like,
Bent. Can we drown him in his own
tentacles? No offense, Baba, but that's nasty.
You asked to see them.
That's true. What the hell are you?
A papaya. Go.
A papaya? That's a fruit. You taught me that.
If I can't feel disappointment, actually disappointing.
That was great, I like that a lot.
Thank you.
Papaya?
Hey, papaya?
That's one of the fruits you taught me. There's coconuts too.
Just get on your way. I'll see you when you return back, hopefully. If there are any problems, you're aware of what you're meant to do, correct?
Run?
Insert tutorial message. Would you like to see the tutorial here?
Skip.
No, but you do it too aggressively and you end up replaying the tutorial.
It's the worst.
That's
like,
worst, dude.
Come on. Once you are up there, if the doors are breached, you are to either ring the bells or light the braziers. They will warn us that they are coming. We will come to your aid as...
Like the Braziers.
I didn't want to say. Daddy, I think you mean Brazier.
I think it's Brazier. Your accent, Pops. I think it's the accent.
Braziers are on women. I think you freaking the whore. Oh. Intelligent to check it.
Yeah, it's true.
Nine.
I have no idea. Braziers. What the fuck are you guys talking about? Braziers are the things you light on fire. Right?
Yeah,
Braziers.
This is a very emotional moment.
No,
Can you please go?
It's just a pronunciation.
Let's go!
Yes, Papa. Papa!
Goodbye.
Goodbye. I will not miss you.
Papa.
What?
It's not very nice.
It's not very nice.
This is the last time you see each other. You like your son.
Not miss you specifically.
Just cast a comment spell. Apologize.
The odds of dying are so minimalistic. There's no way anything will happen. Foreshadowing intensifies.
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. You're going to be fine.
But I incite that foreshadowing.
Sure.
It's a four. Well, I'm sure you're right, Papa.
Yeah,
nothing bad could possibly happen. With my brothers here, we will be perfectly safe.
What could go wrong?
Now come, let us empty our sacks and start the fire.
Da.
What? No, you have to get to the cabin.
What?
Da. Cabin. Yeah, da. Sorry.
Okay. Jesus fucking.
I start drinking early today.
Don't worry, the place won't burn down. Yeah. If it does, that means the people are coming up here, at least. Yeah.
Staring.
He's now wondering why he's, like...
It's like
us.
Maybe these guys weren't the best option. This is like the C team.
Yeah, not even the B.
It's basically him.
Copyright flags.
Oh god.
Oh my god. It's basically,
basically your character, right?
No, I'm the D team. Because
making your way up the mountain, the air gets very thin. It starts getting very hard to breathe.
Oh, my pull fucking over. Nips could cut glass. I pull over the winter cloak over the chain now because it gets really cold.
Yeah, lots of wintery stuff.
Yeah.
So you guys kind of can clamber all the floof you have and shit like that. So
floof? How high up is the snow?
I'm basically just a walking mound of floof.
What's the AC on floof?
Floof has an AC of 12.
Do we get full cover if we're hiding in the floof?
Does that
yes?
AC
technically,
of
yeah,
stack?
They do.
No, it's just literally floof.
I'm getting cold, so at this point I literally take you off my shoulders and I just
plonk me back down.
No,
and
not plonk. I drop you and you just disappear into the snow.
Oh, nice. I'd like to make a stealth check.
Sure. You auto succeed.
Oh.
With a natural two?
With a natural two.
You still auto-succeed because you're He's in gone. The snow.
Yeah, the natural two is as a result of I've lost myself for a moment.
Exactly.
Oh God, where am I?
What's going on? Why is everything so white?
Don't be off shoulder, of course.
You have a moment as you're floating through space seeing four people around the table in a random studio. And you suddenly come back.
I'm just there. Get him the drink! Get him the drink!
Actual flashbacks to my Salvia trips.
Oh my god.
Where am I? What's going on?
Alrighty.
Jesus Christ.
So does anyone proficient with how to make their way around the fort? I'm looking at a ranger.
Yeah, I've got mountains as my favorite terrain.
Fuck man, you're right in this place.
I can't get lost.
Alright, I'm following you at that point. Like,
Duck, please, Chico, lead the way.
Alright, boys. I think I'll lick my finger, put it up, and I listen to it.
You listen.
I listen to it.
The whistling of the wind off of the.
I go, I think it's that way. I start walking.
I follow Chico.
As
you guys are kind of making your way up the areas, I said that's very, very cool. And you are sensing like the winds are kind of trying to push you back down the mountain.
Okay. Should I make a survival check, leader?
All survivals?
That's a 14 plus 6. Okay, so 20 total.
That's a 13 plus 2. 15 total.
Do I need to roll one?
Yes, please.
Yeah, a survival? Yeah.
Keep in mind, guys, we cannot get lost in my terrain. Like, we can't. And we also move at max speed.
20 just saved it because this was a group check.
Oh, nice. I pick them up and I just.
Yeah, nice. Like, we need the weight. We need the weight.
Football carry them, just start running up the hillside.
20 and a 15. How did the natural save? The natural 20 save us?
You probably rolled like an 18 or a 19 or something like that.
Yeah, yeah. Brings the average back up.
Oh, it was a combo.
Yeah, yeah. Combino.
Yeah. So, you guys managed to finally make your way to the cabin. As you push open the door, a large smell of like wet rot. If you know that smell, like old Maltese house.
I'd like to insight. Is it dangerous black mold? It's not good.
It's not good.
It's not good. It's not good. It's 12.
You try to insight by licking it.
No,
let me.
It's not yeast.
Does it smell like dangerous black mold? It is very unsafe.
So you're
going to
be cut off from your yeast supply.
Moss, but not mold.
No moss, no mold.
So you're going to start getting older, man.
Can I roll investigation? I want to find the source of this vile, rancid smell.
I have my shield out.
plus 4 plus 2, 17.
You begin making your way over to the main area, which there's a very large, like, bare rug in the middle of the room.
Hans!
You mean, like, the rug is threadbare, or it's a bare rug?
It's a... no, it's like a... it's an actual bearskin
rug.
Yeah, okay.
And you see, on top of the fireplace, like, there's a very large... the skull is very ornamental. The antlers themselves seem to be made out of lead and silver.
Dope.
And... as you kind of look around, on the side there is this carcass, semi-bubbling and festering.
Bubbling and festering.
This is the place here?
I go up to the carcass, I go...
it's bubbling.
It smells bad to you.
I'm like, okay. I wouldn't eat that.
Stay in the big
Home, I take 10 feet back. If he says I won't eat that, I am fucking...
Cover your mouth. It might be dangerous to breathe.
Apologies. Yeah.
I would like to make Arcana check. Is there anything magical about this bubbling cadaver?
Sure, by all means, make a check.
9.
I have
advantage now.
Times
2 my proficiency bonus.
This is yours. That's why I was trying to keep them separate.
That's 17 total with the 9.
How much?
17 on my Arcana check.
17. It is not Arcana in nature. There's
no
magic.
No, it's just
here.
Disgusting. It's
it
just rotting.
Probable food left over from the previous people that had gone moldy.
What was a corpse?
That's
a
human
corpse.
You don't know if what.
Oh, Chico was in there, so you never know.
Oh, shit.
Chico was in the old body. Okay.
Who knows?
So,
gentlemen, please, can we get this out of here?
Hold on a second. Can I get like a meat hook and a rope and just go and just drag it out?
Sure. I'll allow you to.
Okay.
You kind of do
I'll
that.
I'll drag it
as
out
because
I'm pretty
dragging
sure.
It, you are leaving like dumpster juice all
over.
It's seeping into the floor.
No.
Like,
boys, it is
get
our
it out
first
quick,
night
come on.
Here. I vote we have spring cleaning montage.
I know. I pop a bit of the vodka bottle out and I just start pouring it over it. It's gonna just get rid of it.
You use your elbow grease and spit.
God, man, you really know how to spit. That was a loogie.
Yeah. Like, it hurts every time I make the noise, to be honest with you.
As you are dragging it, it semi-rolls. It looks similar to the equivalent of a... What the hell are they called? Those creatures from Rick and Morty.
Amazing.
A Cronenberg
monster?
No.
It's a Cronenberg monster?
It looks like an actual Cronenberg. It's just
Cronenberg.
So blistered and deformed.
Oh, gross.
That's
I have iron belly. I can eat that shit, but I'm not going to.
You wouldn't.
I'm not going to eat that shit anyway. So we get out of the cabin. Can we clean this cabin up?
You spend the better part of the next 4 hours cleaning it up.
Yeah.
Perception as we go, an investigation. Anything else besides the big ornamental...
Okay, so essentially in this cabin, there's around enough space for around 30 people in here.
Damn.
It's quite a large, it's similar to an actual winter's lodge, if you will. Mm-hmm. In the lower level, there is like this steam sauna, which you guys can use sparingly.
Oh, shit.
Which can
I was probably in there until they forced me out to come clean the house.
Which can double down as a fighting arena to basically hone your skills. There are training dummies within it.
Oh, cool.
Some are made out of hay, some are covered in like rusted suits of armor.
Okay.
And there are like tapestries of previous generations, the
mm-hmm.
doors, and it basically depicts the story of Marita.
Okay, the island itself.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So overall, there isn't really much else that you can see.
No secret doors?
Roll an investigation check with disadvantage.
With disadvantage? Even
can I assist him?
Then
to negate the disadvantage. Alright. You ready? I wish I had kept that. It's 10.
Plus.
Is it 10?
Investigation plus 2 plus
6.
One. It's 6? Yeah.
I think. Because you're proficient, aren't you?
No.
Oh, bugger. No, just 4.
No, I just could take my proficiency bonus. Yeah, I am proficient.
18.
It's plus 4. So it's 4 plus, 14, yeah.
You just make the check.
Oh, nice.
Mm.
Oh, secrets.
Yeah. As you begin kind of going through the sauna, you find that one of the tiles is loose.
Oh my.
As you pull it up, you find that there is a ladder leading downwards.
The boys, you might want to come see this.
Yeah?
Are we really stopping with the cleaning?
What is it?
Yes, we can stop for now.
Fucking great. I throw it down.
Did you
throw
finish
the
your section? Gerald, did you finish your section?
Yeah, sure. What's this thing you were talking about?
There is a ladder, Gerald. The ladder leading downstairs.
I'll go down first, at least.
I think it might be a bit too small for you, Gerald. It is one tile.
It's a 5-foot tile.
That's a big... How did I move a 5-foot tile?
No, you didn't. You, like,
peaked.
I mean, I do have 14 strength.
Exactly.
So it's not... I'm a pretty strong little gnome.
It's
okay.
This thin.
Okay.
I walk
it's
up to that.
Paper mache,
I'm like,
literally
how the fuck did you move that?
Equivalent of this thin.
Okay. Okay. But I'd also, because he asked me the question, I'd like to make another flex check.
Yeah.
That's a natural 20 on this flex check.
I'm gonna flex. I'll flex you back.
Flex the shit out of me.
Just I shrink a bit.
Being a bard.
I got a bardic inspiration.
You give everyone.
We all got bardic inspiration from my epic flex.
Nice. 1d4 to any check, yes. Basically.
For
oh,
the next hour.
Nice, cool. Well, as much as I think that is a good idea, you are the strongest of us, of course, Gerald, to go down the hole. You also cannot see in the dark.
This is true.
And I do not want to alert anything that might be down there.
Yeah,
do not want to
fuck
alert.
You guys in dark visions, I'll be yeah, honest. Like that. Well, you know,
to roll a perception check.
I would love to roll a perception.
You know what? Sure.
Let's all look together.
Look
nah,
down
they're
hole.
Doing that. I'm walking to wherever there's like a lamp. Scan the lamp off the wall and just kind of
16.
Like
okay.
Hooking it, yeah, hooking it to myself at that point.
I got a 16.
Can I ask something? Because I don't have proficiency in perception yet, but because I got observed and plus one to perception, should I take it as a skill? Oh, dope. Now I'm perceptive as well.
I can see things.
8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. He got
how much?
14, 16. 16.
16.
You combine this level of 20.
Oh shit,
you just made the check.
Oh nice.
Hmm? As you guys are kind of standing
yeah,
like, over the
oh,
hole,
no, yeah, yeah.
You can't help but hear the sounds of just like...
Do you hear the scuttling of dirty little creatures?
The dirty little critters whisper?
Hey guys, what are you looking at? I've got my lamp, we can head down.
Hey,
no?
Yeah, Gerald, go down, let's go check
sure,
it out.
Sure, alright.
No, Gerald, Gerald, please, Gerald, Gerald.
Do any of you speak undercommon?
That would probably be a good thing to pick, wouldn't it?
No, I don't. Damn it.
We never discussed my bonus language as a result.
Getting
undercommon. Okay, why not?
Because I'm saying so.
Okay, but we never discussed my bonus languages. We said we're going to deal
with
it.
I speak Goblin.
You basically didn't. You basically had the option of either getting that or getting a language.
Oh, I remember. I took the plus two.
Remember?
Yeah, well, why
that's
would I
basically
not?
How I made it work. So you guys get a certain amount of things depending on your intelligence checks. I hope you enjoyed that. That's an experiment.
Can I?
Yep.
Holy shit. Oh. No, never mind.
What would you like to do?
No, stupid. Not
do
enough
it.
Time. Not enough time.
Do it.
Not enough time. Because I can use my tinkerer's tools to create little automatons.
You guys can seal this back up and try and do it
yeah,
tomorrow.
And try and like deal with it later.
So, what are we going to put on it?
What I think
you
we
moved
should...
it. You're pretty weak.
Well, I think we should
actually,
do it right now.
You're 16.
Come on, come on.
Screw you and your like insane stats.
I know,
stats.
They're ridiculous.
I'm a paladin.
You should watch the video, man. I was like, oh.
Or I think this is a good point to actually call to this session.
Yeah. Us looking down a hole.
Let's put
a
big a
hole,
like thing, a barrel on top of the.
Yeah, and you basically hear that there are sounds from it and a certain amount of voices.
If we're gonna do
that's
it tomorrow,
as fuck.
Do my eldritch cannons persist throughout
you
the night?
1 hour.
1 hour?
Oh, 1 hour.
Then. Okay.
All right. So I hope you all enjoyed today's session.
Actually,
yeah.
You know what? Then just before we go to bed, I put an alarm around the tile.
Good idea.
Well, good
job.
You got
yeah.
An inspiration for next time because that was a good idea.
I was gonna put a barrel.
Great idea.
Out of nowhere, a fucking Megazoid troll just like.
Oh, please, no trolls. No trolls. I haven't seen the new season of that yet.
Oh, neither have I.
Me either.
I haven't seen the new
season. So, I hope you enjoyed today's.
Yes, it was a really good session. Thank you so much,
guys. Oh, great time.
And thank you, guys.
Oh, yeah, thank you, everybody.
Secret Canadian handshakes.
Simking, thanks, Entrix. Are you the only two guys here?
Oh.
Well, thank you regardless.
Yeah, thank
no
you for
joke.
Everyone who's watching.
We'll be back probably in 2 weeks for next week's Christmas. So.
Fuck that.
We're not going to have a Christmas stream? I want to beat the crap out of Santa Claus.
Oh, yeah.
I want
to
be the naughty
I mean,
boy who got cold
honest,
and goes
to be honest, I'd be down for a Christmas stream. I mean, whatever.
What do you think is... Next week's Christmas, isn't it?
Yep.
But
if you,
yeah.
Well,
next
no,
Friday.
It's
yeah.
Christmas Eve.
Oh yeah, shit.
This
it
would be Christmas
week?
Eve.
Weekend, week.
I thought you guys said you couldn't on Christmas Eve.
No. I said. I guess we're not doing one because it's Christmas Eve.
I need to check if the studio is available.
The one thing is that I. Would